the Liberty Beat for Friday, February 20th, 2015. I'm Brian Hagan, reporting. Reminding you, spread liberty with a smile.
The Subway restaurant chain has reacted with shock this week after executives discovered that many customers are apparently purchasing footlong sandwiches and eating the entire 12 inches by themselves. A spokesperson for the company addressed reporters this morning.
This is not how our products are intended to be consumed. Our footlong subs have always been meant to be shared among two or more friends. Eating an entire foot of food shouldn't be possible for most people, but they've been doing it somehow, and it needs to stop.
To encourage healthier eating habits, Subway is clarifying its marketing, adjusting language on menus, and in television commercials like this one.
$5 footlongs? Wow, that's $2.50 per person.
Subway's corporate leadership says they were horrified to learn of the misunderstanding.
It's frightening. I mean, you don't see people eating entire pizzas by themselves. We even cut the footlongs in half into two regular size sandwiches before handing them to you. But I guess that wasn't clear enough.
This is the Onion News Network.
It's Free Talk Live. You can dial toll free here and bring up anything that you might want to discuss. The toll free number is 855-450-FREE, 855-450-3733, live Sunday edition of the program with you here tonight. You've got Ian.
And Mark.
And we've got Skype, by the way. You can Skype into the show at username lrn.fm. According to CNN, there's a new Department of Homeland Security intelligence report warning of the so-called threat from the sovereign citizens. Yes, they're dragging out the old domestic terror threat, fear-mongering situation. We'll get into that here in a moment. Your calls, of course, about whatever you want to discuss. We've got Alma on the line in Florida. You're on Free Talk Live. Alma.
Sweetie, Ian and Mark, you know, I called last night about I don't claim to be a patriot anymore, but, well, today I listened to the cheesy talk shows. Now, Democrats and Republicans are calling Obama a patriot. Yeah. I'm not going to ride in the same boat with him.
Yeah, yeah. This is Rudy Giuliani apparently came out and said that, you know, Barack Obama, I don't remember what the exact quote was, but that somehow he's a bad American or something like that.
Oh, yeah. And who paid? Who pay him?
Right, and you know, he's a government employee, just like everybody.
They're all the same to me. I mean, I can't tell the difference between Rudy Giuliani and Barack Obama.
What's a Democrat? What's a Republican? They look like the same thing to me.
Yep, two sides.
I want to ask you one question before y'all go. What do y'all feel about voting? I'm trying to find out what y'all feel about things.
Yeah, sure. Good question. It's an issue that has come up and likely will come up again and again on Free Talk Live.
Every time voting season comes around.
As voting season arrives. The answer for you is that the hosts on the show feel differently, at least not necessarily tonight. Mark, you and I both vote, but some hosts on Free Talk Live
But you don't vote in federal
not.
Elections because you don't pay federal income tax. Is that right?
Don't generally, I don't think, but I don't have a prohibition against it. I mean, I do still pay for the federal government through gas taxes and things like that, so I don't feel like there's a prohibition on it. I don't really care about federal elections.
Do you vote?
Oh, yeah, we both vote, but there are some hosts on the show who don't, so I don't know if
I used to. This was the first year I didn't. I voted since I was, and I'm 60, since I was 18, I voted.
Why did you stop?
Like my vote is not being counted.
Mm.
It's a joke.
Well, do you guys have the electronic voting machines there where you are?
Yeah, we're to computers now.
How does that make you feel?
I have been on the old-timey ones, and I've had to come out of those things and go, hello, my vote did not go down. Someone has messed with the machine. I had to go back there and flip some buttons to make my vote go in.
Oh, jeez.
Hmm. Alma, thanks for the call tonight. Appreciate it. Toll-free number is 855-450-FREE.
So, obviously, I live in a town where you fill in a slip of paper with a pencil, and then you put it in a box. And then anybody
really?
Can...
Really? They use pencil?
Yes.
Huh.
And then anybody can be there to count the votes with the vote counters at the end. So, I mean, you know, there's not that many interested people. It's not that big of a town.
Right.
But you could be there to count the votes. And that makes me confident that the votes for the town are correct. Now, as we start going up, it starts getting more complicated because, you know, you start moving my town's in a four-town district to vote on representatives and that sort of state representatives and that sort of thing. So, you know, that has to be counted in different areas. Then you're talking about gubernatorial votes. Those have to be sent to Concord in a sealed box. I don't know what happens to the sealed box. And so as far as a vote counting, I'm confident that my vote generally counts. I am not confident that my vote generally matters. And this is a difference that is really extremely important. And let me explain this. So I think that Barack Obama won, maybe it was 2008, maybe it was 2012 or whatever. He won New Hampshire by about 60,000. If I could go back and change my vote in some way in that election, it wouldn't make a difference in any way, shape, or form.
Okay.
Because if he gets, 60,002 or 58,098, it doesn't make a difference because he won the election. So it doesn't matter even if it counts.
But some local elections, people can win by one, two, three,
absolutely.
Four votes.
I'm just making the point that I don't believe every electoral college vote in the U.S. presidential vote is essentially its own election. So if you count every electoral college vote that's existed from now until the beginning of the nation, I don't suspect your one vote, or even if there's four voting people in your household, I don't suspect that there has been a single election of those probably 1,000 or more elections for president. And you got to follow me on how that works. I don't think that a single one of those things changes one single electoral college vote. If you had four votes that you could change in any one of those elections throughout history back to 17, whatever, it wouldn't change the election for president. That's why I say it doesn't matter.
At the federal level.
Yeah, at the federal level.
Because we have seen things. There was truck in your town that won by one vote, right? Like
yep.
The funding, $200,000 for some fire truck.
It wasn't a fire truck. It was a city truck.
Whatever, some kind of truck.
Yeah.
The
fire truck came next year.
That you could have had you gone to that election, but you were actually down in Florida trying to get a pardon, which ultimately didn't work out for you.
Nope.
That one vote you could have cast could have been enough to stop that thing from happening. So,
it could have for that year.
For that year, sure.
And it likely would have gone through the next.
Well, maybe, maybe not. Maybe some free staters would move into town and then it would lose even more by the next election. So I think votes do matter, especially in New Hampshire, where we actually have a movement of people who love freedom who are coming here. We actually, Mark, you and I just came back from Social Sundays, which is a kind of a local hangout event for liberty activists.
Must have been 2 dozen people there at least.
I would say over the entire time there were 2 dozen there, which is not atypical. We're usually a 15 to 20, but there were a couple of new movers from California, and another guy actually just moved from California. There were a bunch of people there from California, Florida, and New York, like three of the worst places to live.
Florida's not so bad comparatively. It's certainly populous.
It's not as bad as California and New York, but it's pretty bad because most of the people from New York moved to Florida.
I talked about on Saturday night that John Locke Foundation or whatever is rating Florida the number one state for freedom.
It's ridiculous.
And I looked at it a bit more, and apparently they rated it on four factors.
Mm-hmm.
The Mercatus Center, which has ranked New Hampshire number one three times, rates on 200 factors.
That's a huge difference.
Four. Well, yeah, it's only a difference of 196.
Yeah. Let's talk to Stephen. He's in Michigan. You're on Free Talk Live, Stephen. Hey there, you're on the air.
Can you explain the philosophy of libertarianism to me?
Sure.
Oh, sure, that's easy. You should the ideas of liberty based around the concept that you should allow people to live free so long as they don't hurt anybody else, or that you should be able to live free so long as you don't hurt anybody else.
They usually are very specific about force and fraud.
Yeah, not to use aggressive force against other peaceful people and to not defraud people.
Yeah, so
did that answer the question for you?
Yes, sir.
Anything else you want to share?
Nope.
Thanks for the call. Toll-free number is 855-450-FREE.
Yeah, I think that the ideas of liberty really sort of, in their basic sense, resonate with people. Well, that makes sense. You wouldn't want to use aggressive force on people.
People would not want to use violence against people.
It sounds like the golden rule in many ways. It just sort of makes sense. Now, when you realize that we have given a special classification of life on Earth to people who work for the government, and we allow them The idea is that we as a society have given them agency over violence and fraud too, because the police can lie to you and it's just fine.
They're trained to lie to you.
The federal government keeps all kinds of secrets from you. As a matter of fact, they've really ramped up that secret keeping in the last end of the Bush administration and all throughout the Obama administration. This is to say the president who ran on transparency is the least transparent presidency in forever. And when you think about this agency known as the government or the state or whatever it is, and you realize that, oh, they're not allowed to do that stuff either, then it gets really strange. Like, that's when sort of the real philosophy kicks in, as you realize, oh, we have an organization of people that use violence and lies to get what they want, and we think it's okay. That's a problem.
I don't think that's okay.
We as a society. I'm talking about we as human
beings.
I'm
not a part of that society.
Yes, you are. You're one that has 46 chromosomes.
A society is a voluntary organization of individuals who've come together for a common cause.
I'm talking about we as humans, okay? And you are part of that group.
I don't recognize
them. The vast majority of humans believe that that's okay.
Toll-free number is 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733. That's because those people don't want to see the violence. They want to pretend like it's not there. And they get really uncomfortable when you point it out to them. 855-450-FREE, like uncomfortable to the point of they might get really violent themselves in some cases. It's Free Talk Live. More coming up. Share your thoughts.
Are you searching for your soulmate? Someone you can trust who will never betray you or cooperate with the NSA? Stop searching. With EasyDNS, you found a keeper. EasyDNS does it all. Domain names, web hosting, and managed WordPress hosting. EasyDNS stands up for your internet freedom, and with servers in Canada, they do not cooperate with the NSA. Go to EasyDNS.com. You'll love their services or get a full refund. They guarantee it. And they accept Bitcoin. That's EasyDNS.com.
For deals on the latest hardwood flooring trends, get to Lumber Liquidators. Don't settle for the stuff at the big box stores. We've got all the hottest flooring styles for less, like the timeless look of real oak. This week, get pre-finished oak hardwood for less than you'd pay for laminate at other stores. Now, it's an incredible 99 cents. Or get 3/4-inch solid pre-finished red oak for $2.59. Plus, it's your last chance to save $500 on Bellawood. Get deals on bamboo, laminates, and more from 49 cents. And special financing. Don't miss this season's hottest hardwood deals. Visit LumberLiquidators.com to find a store near you.
On the average, Americans work between 45 to 50 years, hoping to build up enough wealth to retire and live out their golden years. Unfortunately, with taxation, the rising cost of food, energy, housing, and medical, many retirees are forced to live below the poverty line. Is this a flaw of free enterprise, or is our monetary unit we call the Federal Reserve Note forcing us into perpetual debt, ensuring inflation and higher taxes? These questions and more can be answered by reading G. Edward Griffin's book, The Creature from Jekyll Island. Congressman Ron Paul states, "It's what every American needs to know about central bank power. A gripping adventure into the secret world of international banking cartel." Hi, this is Ted Anderson. I will give a silver dollar from the early 1900s to anyone who purchases this book. Call 1-800-686-2237 and order a copy today. It's critical that the public be made aware of the system. Call and order your copy today at 1-800-686-2237. That's 1-800-686-2237.
What if the key to achieving liberty in your lifetime was to move together with others who think like you? Liberty activists are joining the Free State Project, which is over 70% of the way to its goal of 20,000 participants. And they're already making the move to New Hampshire. The successes are piling up and are proving the Free State Project is a real movement and no longer just a great idea. When you're planning your move, consider Keene. Keene is famous for its civil disobedience and non-cooperation, and there's plenty of political opportunity as well. From demonstrations and vigils to outreach and volunteering, there's a lot going on in Keene. Keene is the liberty media capital of the world, with television, talk radio, and more all originating here. Though it's more than just activism, with regular social events each week. See what's happening at freekeene.com and get connected with video, audio, free books, a forum, and activist tools you can download and use in your area at freekeene.com. That's freekeene.com.
The three most important things you can do for Free Talk Live are, one, share one episode a week on Facebook or in some other social networking site. Two, buy the things you buy online through shop.freetalklive.com. Three, give $5 a month to the AMP program. It's my firm belief that Free Talk Live's AMP program is the best use of your charitable dollar among liberty-oriented organizations. Support all the organizations you love. But make sure you give $5 a month to AMP at amp.freetalklive.com. Radio is the most personal of mediums. I exist right now in your head. If you listen to Free Talk Live regularly, you know me. Free Talk Live is on more than 160 radio stations around the U.S. and has been downloaded on every continent around the world. Hundreds of thousands of listeners with ad packages from $600 a month to $6,000 a month. Imagine what we can do for your business, project, website, or idea. Email me, Mark at freetalklive.com.
You can put the Liberty Radio Network on the air in your area. Visit broadcast.lrn.fm to learn how. Broadcast.lrn.fm.
This is Free Talk Live. You can bring up anything you'd like. The toll-free number is 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733. You can join us online at freetalklive.com. And by the way, it is the live Sunday edition of the program. If you enjoy this program, then please shop with us at shop.freetalklive.com. You enter Amazon through the links there. You'll find at shop.freetalklive.com, and Free Talk Live gets a cut of the sale. Very simple. shop.freetalklive.com.
Hey, I need some information from you. Free Talk Live, you know, we're an ad venue, like so many ad venues out there, and we sell ads for a living. One thing you need when you sell ads for a living is sort of some qualitative data, is what they call it, which means I want to know what your gender is. I want to know how old you are. I want to know a few things about you. And I've got a deal that I would like to exchange with you. I have three gift certificates. They're $50 for a t-shirt company that has some really cool t-shirts, and it'd be fun to go there and pick out the ones you want. I'd like them to send me some, but they haven't really offered that. Anyway, that's not my, no business of yours. Is all you have to do is go to demo.freetalklive.com and fill out my listener survey. It is not complicated. For instance,
how long is it going to take me?
5 minutes tops.
Okay. All right.
And also, like, I don't ask all, like, I refuse to ask the race question, so there's only one answer, human. 73% of people have answered that they are, in fact, human.
That's good. The rest are aliens.
Well, I just don't like the race question particularly, so I just decided to ask my own, and then if somebody asks me about the race of my demographics, I can say, well, 73% of them responded that they were human. And that'll throw off the people that are asking the questions. Nonetheless, I thought it was amusing. International listeners can win. As a matter of fact, some of them have gone and signed up. And thank you very much for you Europeans. I would certainly love to have listeners on every continent on the planet sign up, because that would be really awesome. We've had callers from every continent. But if you fill out the survey, you will be entered to win, and in all future contests that have to do with the survey, too. This particular drawing for these three $50 gift certificates will be held on March the 1st at noon Eastern. And that's when the cutoff for the drawing may be a little later from that, but nobody after that gets to do it. So that, anyway, it's demo.freetalklive.com to sign up. I'd appreciate it, and I intend to reward you. Potentially. Demo.freetalklive.com.
All right. CNN is reporting on the domestic terror threat of the so-called sovereign citizens. Yes, they're in the news again.
Always in the news.
Not always, but every now and then they trot them out as a sort of fear-mongering approach to try to get people afraid of the idea that their neighbors might be crazed killers and that they need the government to keep them safe from them. CNN reporting they're carrying out sporadic terror attacks on police. Now, it's interesting. Before the whole war on terror thing, if somebody shot a cop, that would just be, you know, killing a cop. It wouldn't be a terror attack on police. What is it that makes, how can you tell the difference between a terror attack on police and an attack on police? Are there any attacks on police anymore, or are they all considered to be terror attacks?
I'd say that the vast majority, you know, I think that if you're just sort of like some gang members rolling in and you want to shoot up the police station, that's not a terror attack. I think that would just be an attack on police. But
the sovereign citizen, usually what they're referring to is that incident down in, I don't know, the south somewhere where a couple guys got pulled over randomly.
Beliefs would be the claim behind that. So
and then they shot the hell out of the cop.
Yeah, I gotcha. Yeah. And they absolutely did. But I would say that with 1,100 killings in the last, in 2014 by police, that just statistically, the police have to have killed more innocent people than sovereign citizens, right?
Oh, yeah. I mean, the sovereign citizen guys are hardly ever in the news for actually attacking something. Usually they keep dredging up the same old incident from 4 or 5 years ago or whatever it was.
Right. So if you, so if you're taking in the last decade, you want to look at the amount of innocent people killed by police versus the amount of police, who I would say all of whom were killed by sovereign citizens or sort of innocent-y. You know, some people might disagree with me. But if you just compare all the people killed by all the police, any people killed by sovereign citizens because they're sovereign citizens, versus all the innocent people killed by police, that the organization that is most terroristic would then be policing organizations in the United States. I don't believe that. But if you're going to use terminology like terrorism, then that it has to be applied equally everywhere,
well,
right?
Well, no, to be fair, this is just CNN's editorial comment, right? This is just the writer.
I'm only trying to hold CNN accountable for their terminology.
Yeah, I'm just making it clear. I don't know if that particular terminology came from the government press release. It may have. A lot of these news articles, I'm putting quotes around the news articles part here, a lot of these things are essentially regurgitations of some government press release, and that's what they're referring to here, is this DHS intelligence report that is warning of this right-wing threat, the sovereign citizens. And if they are referring to this as terror attacks on police, like that one incident where they're just on the side of the interstate, they've been pulled over and they shoot up some cop to death, shouldn't a terror attack be premeditated? Like, by definition, the idea of terrorism is to use violence or the threat of violence to achieve some sort of a political goal.
I think there's some argument for what you're making here, but I think you're just harping on the terrorism term a little too much.
The reason I'm harping on it is because they're suggesting that the sovereign citizens are domestic terrorists. And I'm saying that if you get pulled over, if somebody gets pulled over by the police and they're crazy and they go into a shootout with the police at that moment, that wasn't a premeditated attack. I mean, I guess you could argue that it was, in that they had a gun and they knew that if the cops pulled them over, then they might do something. But they didn't necessarily think, oh, well, you know, I'm going to do this so I can take the police out or destroy the system. That's just an act of defense in that particular case.
I think it's a good argument for what you say.
Yeah, so I don't consider that to be terrorism, but obviously the state is going to, because, well, they want to see as much terrorism as they can possibly see, or at least make you think that there's as much terrorism as they can possibly, you know, make you believe. Because they want you to need them. They want you to want them, to desire their services, to protect you from the scary sovereign citizens. Going on here, a new intelligence assessment circulated by the Department of Homeland Security this month and reviewed by CNN focuses on the domestic terror threat from white right-wing, they're probably white, right-wing sovereign citizen extremists, and comes as the Obama administration holds a White House conference to focus efforts to fight violent extremism. Some federal and local law enforcement groups view the domestic terror threat from sovereign citizens groups as equal to, and in some cases greater than, the threat from foreign Islamic terror groups such as ISIS that garner more public attention. The Homeland Security report, produced in coordination with the FBI.
Well, I mean, ISIS? I don't think ISIS is coming here, so okay, I suppose I agree with that statement. You know, that the sovereign citizens are a threat to power because they don't recognize the power of these policing organizations the way they want their power recognized. So I suppose they're a threat in that way. Yes. Anybody who does not adhere thoroughly to the state's line is really, it's a dissident, right? I mean, that's the terminology. And all they're trying to do is conflate a person, a terrorist, with a dissident.
That's exactly what they're doing here. And they're going to give you some numbers here about how many alleged attacks there have been by so-called sovereign citizens here in a moment. Our toll-free number is 855-450-FREE. Are you afraid of the sovereign citizen threat? Do you consider yourself a sovereign citizen? Would love to hear from you. 855-450-FREE. You can take control here on Free Talk Live. There's more coming up.
This is Dan Pilla. Do you owe the IRS money you can't pay? Are tax debts crippling you? I've defended people from the IRS for over 30 years. I've helped thousands, and I can help you too. I wrote the book on IRS settlement, and I'm telling you, there's no such thing as a hopeless case. Call 800-34-NO-TAX to finally get free of IRS debt. With the IRS's new programs, there's never been a better time to solve your problem. Call 800-34-NO-TAX. That's 800-34-NO-TAX or my website, danpilla.com.
It's no secret that government and big business buy in bulk and get huge discounts not available to the little guy. Until now. Introducing a breakthrough crowd buying website where people can join together, buy in bulk, and get massive discounts on millions of popular products. It's TogetherSave.com. TogetherSave.com. You can save 20, 30, or even 50% off tablets, smartphones, cars, appliances, textbooks, sports equipment, video games, and much more. All with free delivery. Check it out. TogetherSave.com. Visit now and start group buying today at TogetherSave.com.
Since time began, tyrants have taken aim at personal liberties. Now there's a movie that aims back.
The government has no more right to tell us what to put in our bodies than they have to take our guns or tell us what books we can read.
Six drug police were eaten by bears while raiding a marijuana farm.
On your knees, you dirty hippies!
Jesus.
On your knees!
What's the problem, officer?
Today, many cops who enforce pot laws do so only because it provides them with cushy jobs, good benefits, and a chance to push people around.
I was an undercover narcotics officer. The drug war is nothing but a farce.
The Second Amendment says you gotta keep you and your gat intact.
Guns and Weed, the road to freedom. A film by Michael W. Dean and Nima Vadavi.
DVD available now at gunsandweed.com or on Amazon. That's gunsandweed.com. Makes the perfect gift. Remember, that's gunsandweed.com.
If there was a place that liberty-minded people had been elected to political positions and were rolling back government, would you move there? If freedom lovers had secured a 20% voting block and can veto most bad bills, would you move? Well, the time has come to sign the pledge at freestateproject.org. These things have happened in New Hampshire, and you can join us and help. freestateproject.org. Sign up now at freestateproject.org.
You can listen to Free Talk Live on the radio, podcast, satellite, webcam, and our live streams. But did you know you can listen to Free Talk Live from any phone, anywhere? Add this number to your phone, 213-493-0308. It's a long-distance call, so make sure you're familiar with your phone's calling plan. The listen lines are airing the latest episode of Free Talk Live 24 hours a day, including our live shows. Call 213-493-0308. That's 213-493-0308.
The Shire Free Church offers a sanctuary to those seeking an escape from state churches.
The Shire Free Church is an interfaith, diverse group of people that may not share identical theological beliefs. As a member in or minister of the Shire Free Church, you are a sovereign individual and may be the faith of your choice.
We don't claim to have all of the answers.
We are open to all peaceful people.
We want to learn from each other.
What unifies the Shire Free Church and its diverse members is peace,
love,
and liberty. There are many paths to God, one for every individual.
The Shire Free Church does not define a specific path beyond those parameters that must be your foundation.
Peace as your way.
Love as your guide.
And liberty as your light.
Learn more at church.shiresociety.com.
That's church.shiresociety.com.
You can connect with the Liberty Radio Network via our Facebook page at facebook.lrn.fm. That's facebook.lrn.fm.
It's Free Talk Live, the live Sunday edition of the program. We'll take your calls about anything you want to discuss. The toll-free number is 855-450-FREE. Are you a so-called sovereign citizen? If you believe the Department of Homeland Security, these guys are all over the place and they're a huge threat. I don't know if I agree, but maybe you can tell us a little bit more. The toll-free number is 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733. We'll get deeper into that here in a moment. But first, I want to tell you how to get free coffee. A pound of some of the best coffee out there. Mark, you drink BuzzBox coffee every single day if you can, correct?
Generally, yeah.
The only reason you won't do it is if you're like flying on an airplane or something like that.
Yeah, if I happen to be away, but sometimes I bring coffee with me on trips.
Coffee.freetalklive.com is where you can go to get a pound of BuzzBox for free. All you have to do is just cover the shipping cost. They'll send you the pound. It's 100% organic, top 1% grade Arabica and shade grown. It's great coffee.
It's really great coffee.
Delivered wherever you want to have it delivered. And you get on an auto ship program, which, by the way, you can cancel your subscription at any time. But more importantly, you can actually adjust the subscription. So you can tell them how often you want a shipment and how much or how large you want that shipment to be. And, of course, what flavor. Coffee.freetalklive.com. Really cool thing about BuzzBox is that the portion of the profits from each pound are going toward helping people get microloans through Kiva.org. Mark, you're the one who's administering these loans. You're deciding who receives the loan, what,
yep.
You know, how much, I guess, they're asking for an amount, and you decide to fund the loan, correct?
Is that how it works? I just did two today.
Well, give me one example.
Well, you know, they're escaping me. I took a nap right afterwards, so I can't remember what the two.
I put you on the spot.
I just can't remember what they were.
Can you give me one from the past?
Yeah, there's a lot of them.
Just one.
Yeah, there was a guy from, for instance, Bolivia who buys used. Like appliances and that sort of thing, and then sells them again. And so he needed more product and that kind of thing. I'm remembering now. One of them was from, I think it was Cameroon, and it was group of people who are trying to buy beans for seeds, mm-hmm. Different types of seeds, and they're putting together several hundred dollars. So I loaned to them, and I just can't remember.
Did you loan them the full amount, or is
no?
No, so it comes from different people.
It comes
right?
from different people. Yes,
so and you in to the loan.
What that does is it spreads out
the risk
too for people. Okay. And at this point, we have had zero non-payments.
Wow, that's outstanding.
Yeah, we've had. We've loaned more than the average person loans on, Kiva, which makes sense. I mean, we're an organization; other people are helping us and stuff
right.
like that. But we've had zero of non-pays. And the amazing
awesome.
Thing is the it's incredible the number of these people that pay. I think that their bad pay rate is 1.3% on average.
They really appreciate the help.
Yeah, right? I mean, these people are like, oh, I got all this money. And by their standards, that's a lot of money, right? I've got all this money loaned to me at, as I understand it, no interest. I'm certainly not getting interest on the money. And, you know, maybe the organizations that do the loan get a small amount in order to do it. I don't mm-hmm. know the answer to that. But I'm going to pay this back so that I can, you know, do this in the future if I need to. So they have a real understanding of what the value is of these loans.
So you can help us fund these loans by becoming a subscriber over at coffee.freetalklive.com. And again, a free pound of coffee is in it for you. Just go to coffee.freetalklive.com and get signed up there. Our toll-free number is 855-450-FREE. The fear-mongering report here from CNN cites a Department of Homeland Security review about the alleged domestic terror threat from right-wing sovereign citizen extremists. The Homeland Security report produced in coordination with the FBI counts 24 violent sovereign citizen-related attacks across the U.S. since 2010. Now, whenever they use the hyphen related in reference to an attack or into anything, whether it's alcohol-related, so for instance, an alcohol-related crash on the interstate can mean the passenger was drunk.
Yeah.
That's an alcohol-related crash. And the way it's presented makes it sound like, my God, it's all, you know, drunk drivers. But in point of fact, they're counting passengers who are drunk as alcohol-related. So when they say it's a sovereign citizen-related attack, what does that really mean?
Also, I'd like to know what the attack means is because I'm sure they will count a resisting arrest charge
as an attack,
right? Mm. Which is a defense in many cases. It may be an unlawful defense, but it's not an attack.
Good point. The government says these are extremists who believe they can ignore laws and that their individual rights are under attack in routine daily instances, such as a traffic stop or being required to obey a court order. They have lashed out against authority in incidents such as one in 2012, in which a father and son were accused of engaging in a shootout with police in Louisiana, which is the one that I referenced earlier, in a confrontation.
Yeah, that's the one that they really, I think that's a legit, right? Like these guys jumped out of this van, they shot those cops. It was, you know, that was a disgusting and vile act.
Well, I mean, it's not the right thing to do in that it's going to make you look bad, but ultimately they were defending themselves
How
from
so?
Attack by the police.
The police were doing what? In what way were they attacking?
They pulled them over. I mean, that's a deprivation of someone's freedom. I totally understand where some of these sovereign citizen guys are coming from. I mean, I don't think they're right about their interpretations of the law or whatever, because a lot of them have these kind of magic theories that they think if they utter certain words that they're going to be able to get out of the government system or whatever. I don't believe in that. But I do understand kind of the Chris Cantwell-esque viewpoint, if you will, that when the police are pulling you over, they are depriving you of your liberty. And if anybody else were to, you know, threaten you with violence to get you to waylay you on the highway, you would be within your rights to use violent force to stop them from doing that. Because they have a badge and a gun, however, means that the whole situation is completely different, because people, when they look at that, they will see the man with the badge and the gun as a legitimate act, what he's doing as legitimate, and the sovereign citizens don't see that as legitimate, and so, I don't blame them for it. I don't think it's the right approach.
I disagree because, with your premise that the police are, at that point are aggressing.
Of course they are.
Turning on your flashing lights and following somebody is not aggressing against them.
It's an indicator that you know what's coming next. Don't pull over, that man is going to try to run you off the road and possibly kill you.
And he'd liable to get all of his other friends to do the same thing.
Yeah.
And I would agree with you that if you continue on, that's what's going to happen and that you will be experiencing. But at that point, you have not experienced aggression. So pulling over and just shooting a cop is, in my opinion, at that point, an aggressive act, not a defensive act.
Really? Huh.
Yes. You can take the ticket, because all the police officer is going to do is hand you a piece of paper.
Oh, not necessarily. Not if the cop sees an AK-47 in the back seat. Not in Louisiana.
Well, I get where you're coming from at that point. They attempt to disarm you.
At that point, that cop may very well try to put you in handcuffs.
Could be. Could be. I don't know the answer to that, but you're still not in an aggressive situation. The cop has discretion and could very well say, I think that you got the right to bear arms. There are police officers out there.
So what you're saying is you don't consider it, when a police officer puts their lights on behind you, you don't consider it aggression until they try running you off the road?
I think you can reasonably consider it a threat.
Well, threats are aggressive, aren't they?
But I don't think that anybody else is going to interpret it that way. So you need to live both in the world of...
Yeah, I agree with you. I didn't say I supported what they were doing, Mark. I just said I understand it.
I understand.
I agree with it too. Yeah.
That's all. But I have rejected it, right? Like, I understand
it's
it as a course of
approach.
Act.
It's not my approach. I choose peace.
Do you reject it?
That's correct.
It's not
my approach. I would not do that personally.
Because I think that's important to say.
But I also understand where they're coming from.
I reject this as a highly inexpedient way to go about bringing a future freer world. As a matter of fact, I would consider it not just inexpedient, but counterproductive, highly counterproductive.
But I'm just empathizing with these guys. I mean, I can understand.
I want to empathize with the police officers' families too. These guys were going out doing the normal job that they do every day that is accepted by the vast majority of the public, and they got shot and killed for really nothing.
Well, for pulling somebody over, that's an aggressive act. I wouldn't say it's for nothing. Anyway, going on here, the government says they believe they can ignore laws and their individual rights are under attack. This is what they think. So, let's see. The men were sovereign citizen extremists who claimed police had no authority over them, which is a nice belief, and, it certainly should be true that all men and women should be created equal, and that one person cannot, by definition, have authority over another person unless that person has somehow given them permission to have that authority. Because if we're all equal, how can somebody be above one of us? So I totally get that. 855-453. More about the sovereign citizens coming up.
So the protection of life, liberty, and property is what the Free State Project is all about. But it's an effort to move 20,000 people who understand.
It's about demonstrating to the entire country
that, yeah, we can have a free market, a truly free market.
Making it just a freer, great place to live.
It's the world's largest voluntarist libertarian community, and it's only getting bigger.
That's amazing, to be able to move to a place where other people like passionately believe in being free and independent.
What the Free State Project is managing to do, though, is to put their money where their mouth is. It's physically getting up across the country and saying, let's go someplace and let's demonstrate the power of these ideas. There's a lot of kind of philosophy that surrounds liberty. There's a lot of thinking about it and talking about it. But here in New Hampshire, people are doing it.
101 Reasons Liberty Lives in New Hampshire, a documentary by Free State Project Early Movers. Watch it free at 101reasonsfilm.com. 101reasonsfilm.com.
Hunters, anglers, campers, and survivalists, get back to nature. Expand your horizons with the highest quality, most versatile, unique slingshots and slingbows on the market at slingbow.com. Slingbow products are compact and models start from just $17.98. They're perfect for your bug-out bag or storing in your vehicle. Give yourself and your loved ones the excitement and tradition of slingbow, a new frontier in archery and truly modern twist on this primitive survival tool. Feel the thrill only at slingbow.com.
This is Rick Osick, president of Famous Footwear. Our company is working together with the March of Dimes through March for Babies to raise money and awareness about the serious problem of premature birth in the U.S. As a business leader, I know that babies born very sick or too soon cost businesses billions of dollars each year, in addition to the emotional stress on employees and their families. That's why Famous Footwear is committed to raising funds to improve the health of moms and babies everywhere. Won't you please join us in the March for Babies? Start a team today at marchforbabies.org.
Why did you move to the Shire?
I moved here to the Shire because there's other people around who take liberty just as seriously as I do.
I moved to the Shire because I saw videos of people challenging authority and thought that I could get support myself. It called to me, like, do this right now.
I wanted to be around people like me who got it. And once I got here, I knew there was nowhere else that I wanted to be.
I've always wanted to change the world. So I moved to the Shire to join people who were actually working towards doing the same thing.
The people here are awesome, loving, and positive. It was for the adventure and for the feeling of something important is happening here, and I just wanted to come to sort of be part of that.
Visit ShireSociety.com to read and sign the Shire Society Declaration and learn the reasons why, if you love liberty, you should immigrate to the Shire. Plus, add yourself to the Shire map at ShireSociety.com. That's ShireSociety.com. Did you know that you can listen to and watch Free Talk Live during our live show 7 days a week from 7 to 10 p.m. Eastern via our studio cam at cam.freetalklive.com? Not only that, but you can also chat with other listeners at the same time. Do I need to mention that both the studio cam and chat room are totally free? Outside of Free Talk Live's live hours, you won't see a cam feed, but we'll hear audio from the Liberty Radio Network. So listen, watch, and chat all free at cam.freetalklive.com. That's cam.freetalklive.com.
This Your Family Today tip is brought to you by Boost Kid Essentials Nutritionally Complete Drink, providing your picky eater with essential nutrition and great taste in one drink. Visit us at kidessentials.com. To make sure your kids eat healthy, follow the 5-a-day plan. Serve 3 servings of vegetables and 2 servings of fruit daily. Remember, a serving could just mean a piece of fruit or a half cup of veggies. If your kids are picky eaters, ask a nutritionist about other sources. For more tips like these, visit us at parenthood.com/yourfamilytoday.
While our satellite channel is free to listen to, it's not free for us. You can help us cover our satellite costs with the chip-in on the right side of the page at lrn.fm.
Hey, it's Free Talk Live. We'll take your calls about anything you'd like to discuss. Just dial in toll-free at 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733. Join us online over at freetalklive.com. All the features, they are totally free. So if you like them, please, you can get behind the show by becoming a Free Talk Live amplifier at amp.freetalklive.com. You get perks like access to the amp-only call-in lines, the amp-only podcast, the amp-only forum, and the amp-only Facebook group. Those are some of the perks, but there are more. Every now and then we get something real special, like Free Talk Live amplifiers who become platinum amplifiers, which is the $25 a month level. The regular level is $5 a month, and gosh, we sure do appreciate that and give you all those perks just for $5 a month. But if you do $25 a month, then you will qualify for the amp shirt that is coming out later on this, like a little closer towards summer. The rules are you have to become a Free Talk Live Platinum Amplifier by March 1st. So you have less than a week to accomplish this. Become a Platinum Amplifier by March 1st. Stay a Platinum Amplifier for at least 2 months, so through May 1st. And then you'll receive one of these very cool amp shirts. They're put on tech fabric, which they're long sleeve shirts and high quality fabric with a word cloud design that you can see for yourself by going to shirt.freetalklive.com. That's shirt.freetalklive.com. And your AMP dollars make a big difference for us. It allows us to get on more radio stations around the country, bring more internet listeners on board, and expose new people to the ideas of freedom. So if that's valuable to you, if it's worth 5, 10, 25 bucks a month, please become an amplifier at amp.freetalklive.com. It makes a big difference for us when you do that. So thank you. That's amp.freetalklive.com. We're talking about an alleged report here from the Department of Homeland Security, CNN reporting on this. The so-called sovereign citizen movement is in the news again, not because anything's happened recently. They're still citing the 2012 incident, which, you know, that's 3 years old at this point, where a father and son were, they had a shootout with police in Louisiana, which did end up with two officers killed and allegedly others wounded in that confrontation. The men were so-called sovereign citizens, and the article labels them extremists who claimed police had no authority over them. Among the findings from the Department of Homeland Security assessment, sovereign citizen violence during 2015 will occur most frequently during routine law enforcement encounters at a suspect's home, during enforcement stops, and at government offices. The report adds that, quote, law enforcement officers will remain the primary target of sovereign citizen violence over the next year due to their role in physically enforcing laws and regulations.
That is their role.
The White House has fended off criticism in recent days for its reluctance to say the words Islamist extremism, even as the conference this week almost entirely focused on helping imams and community groups to counteract the lure of groups like ISIS. Absent from the White House conference is any focus on the domestic terror threat posed by sovereign citizens, militias, and other anti-government terrorists that have carried out multiple attacks in recent years. Now, of course,
so we're harping on the term terrorist again in this article. Yep. Is that the idea? Okay.
An administration official says the White House is focused on the threat from all terrorists, including from sovereign citizen and other domestic groups. The
See, I'm not that fond of the term terrorist. I think that it's just, you know, state speak. It as far as I'm concerned, any organization that rules through fear, which by its definition, the government does that.
That's correct.
You know, I'm fine with calling, you know, the sovereign citizens a terrorist group if that's what you want to do. But let's make sure that we talk about the people in the government who terrify me, right? Yeah. Like, I am terrified of what might happen to me if I don't follow some of their dumb rules they've set up.
Well, I agree
with
you.
Rules that have, you know, that have no real bearing on, they have no business passing.
When you look up terrorism in the dictionary, it's a crystal clear definition of what the government does. Definition number one, the use of violence and threats to intimidate or coerce, especially for political purposes. Now, that's not to say that ISIS isn't a terrorist group. They are too. ISIS, the United States government, really the difference is only in degrees.
All governments.
You're right. All governments. The difference is only in degrees between these agencies.
Now, the government,
I don't think the sovereign citizens qualify as terrorists because ultimately they just want to be left alone. They're not actually trying to, at least in the incidents we've heard about, they're not trying to end the state by attacking it. They just want to be left alone, and when the cops mess with them, they are willing to shoot back, which I think is not a good approach, but that's what they do, some of them.
Yeah, I mean,
not all sovereign citizens. I want to make it clear. They're not all, you know, people who are willing to use violence.
But the governing documents of these organizations, at least in the United States, they often have the term consent in them. When you look when you look at declarations of, you know, the constitutions of states, that you'll see the term consent. It pops up all the time, the consent of the governed. But when you don't give consent anymore, and there's areas of my life that I would like the government out of.
Let's come back to that discussion here. We do have John in Des Moines. He's on. John, you're on Free Talk Live. Welcome. Go ahead.
Yes, I was just wondering, you know, I hear on the news and everything that Obama wanted to give ISIS jobs and everything. Why didn't he give them Obama phones, too? That way they could get a hold of their mothers and stuff, you know, because he's wanting their mothers to go to school and stuff like that to acknowledge and be aware that their sons and stuff are terrorists. That way they can contact their mothers more often and stuff like that.
First of all, John, I don't really know what you're talking about. You're claiming Barack Obama wants to give ISIS jobs? Is that what you said?
That's correct.
Well, Well, I think
that doesn't make much sense.
Well,
does
I think
it?
That the terminology that was used is the idea is that we have to make the Middle East more vital, and that way people will have jobs as opposed to wanting to go work for militias.
Well, here's step one. If you want that to happen, Barack Obama or anyone else, is to leave the Middle East. Get the United States government out of the Middle East so then people can actually, create jobs in buildings that aren't, well, the remains of the buildings that aren't total bombed out husks. I think that would be a good step number one. What do you think, John?
I agree with you 100%.
So you're on board with withdrawing the United States military completely from the Middle East then?
I'm on board with withdrawing. Now, I believe ISIS needs to be taken care of. I don't think we need to be playing foot and mouth with them either.
All right, so I'm a little confused. What were you on board 100% with? Because I had suggested getting the government out of, the U.S. government out of the Middle East. It sounded like you agreed with that, but then you didn't agree with that.
Well, I agree. I agree what I'm saying, sir, is if we're going to be there, then we need to take care of business.
I am not there. Are you there?
Get it done and get it over with.
Just curious. It seems you're calling from Des Moines here tonight. Are you in the Middle East?
No.
Okay, well, then we're not in the Middle East. What were you saying? No. If the United States is going to be there, then what?
If the United States military is going to be there, then let them do their job.
Well, I think that the United States military has done its job in the Middle East over the course of 10 or 12 years that it's been there. I mean,
how long is this job going to go on for?
This is what it looks like when the United States military does its job. The idea that they're being held back in some way doesn't seem very legit to me, especially when there was a major that was quoted in the Iraq conflict that he would give a 3-day pass to the first of his soldiers to kill a Iraqi with a bayonet. It's not like these dogs were on the leash at any point. This is what it looks like when the military is let loose. The area is destabilized. That's why we have organizations
like
ISIS and or ISIL or IS or whatever the heck they're going to be called this week, that have taken over because the area was destabilized. This is the question I would have for you. Do you think Iraq is any better off than before it was invaded?
No, I do not.
That's what I'm saying, right? Like, the place was effed up before the United States showed up. It was effed up when the United States was in it, and it's effed up now. What in the hell did the U.S. military...
It's going to be effed up 100 years from now.
I think that the biggest problem with that, if I have
so
a fear.
So let's stop spending trillions of dollars on trying to F right. it up even more. How about that?
So I think that this is the problem, is prior to the Middle East being sort of carved up by Winston Churchill and those in England and that sort of thing, it was controlled by the Ottoman Empire. These areas haven't really been free for many centuries. Now, these people yearn to be free just like you and I do. And if we let them alone, at some point they will be. Saudi Arabia is ruled by people that apparently aren't even Saudi Arabian. And they call themselves kings and princes. The United States people would never put up with a person that was not from the United States, sort of ethnically or whatever, and then called themselves a king. And why in the world would he expect people in the Middle East to put up with that? That's what the problem is that they were trying to establish this sort of world order, the way things that should be, because it's really convenient for us when the Saudis' government is stable. It's convenient for us to get oil from them. That's why the United States supports it.
John, thanks for the call tonight. I appreciate it. The toll-free number is 855-450-FREE. We are here on the live Sunday edition of Free Talk Live. Plenty of time for you with your thoughts. Plus, coming up, the cops, apparently in the United States, some of them having a tough time hiring, and they're blaming social media. Mark's got the story on the way. It's Free Talk Live.
DVD, books, music, instruments, periodicals, computers, software, electronics, photo, cell phone, office products, home and garden, bed and bath, furniture, kitchen, pet supplies, automotive, hardware, apparel, shoes, jewelry, grocery, healthcare, sports and outdoors, toys, games, used and more. It's a department store at your fingertips. Shop.freetalklive.com. Get all your shopping done, get a great deal, and a portion of your purchase goes to benefit Free Talk Live when you enter Amazon via shop.freetalklive.com.
Kay Oliver is part of the Tweyambe Women's Group in Jinja, Uganda. She gets old clothes, fixes them up, washes them, and then sells them at the Jinja market. She was quite happy with her success at her business, but realized that a sewing machine would really help her make more money to take care of her two kids. Free Talk Live helped her get that sewing machine. You can help us help more people by getting your coffee through coffee.freetalklive.com. Make a difference, one cup at a time. Get a free pound, try out the subscription, cancel at any time, coffee.freetalklive.com.
Are you a political activist who does things that the government might not like? Then this free ebook may save your life. Rats is your guide to protecting yourself against snitches, informers, informants, agents provocateurs, narcs, finks, and similar vermin. Rats was written by OG libertarian Claire Wolfe. Rats is a short book, easy to read, and available free in many formats. Download Rats free at rats-nosnitch.com. That's rats-nosnitch.com.
The three most important things you can do for Free Talk Live are, one, share one episode a week on Facebook or in some other social networking site. Two, buy the things you buy online through shop.freetalklive.com. Three, give $5 a month to the AMP program. You likely buy all kinds of things online. Amazon is the largest online retailer. You can get what you need at the same prices with free Super Saver shipping by going to shop.freetalklive.com. Please do your online shopping at shop.freetalklive.com.
You're listening to the live edition of Free Talk Live. Hour number two is next after the news here on the Liberty Radio Network at LRN.FM.
From Keene in the Shire, the Liberty Media capital of the world, this is Daryl W. Perry, host of FPP Radio News for Sunday, February 22nd, 2015. Silver is trading at $16.25 per ounce. Gold is valued at $1,202 per ounce. And according to BitcoinAverage.com, the average price of Bitcoin is $246. Antiwar.com reports Ukraine's military abandonment of Debaltseve continues to pay dividends for the ceasefire, which is again holding, and prisoner exchanges yesterday add to hopes that the deal will hold. Not that there hasn't been any fighting in the past couple of days, as some shelling has been reported against the rebel capital of Donetsk, though it is minor compared to the fighting before the ceasefire began a week ago. The town of Novozovsk seems to be another potential site of tension, as Ukraine is accusing the rebels of building up on the outskirts and are themselves building up at the town. Novozovsk would be the route through which the fighting would take place in Mariupol, a major port city that would likely be the rebels' next target if the ceasefire falls. It's only natural, as both sides continue to redeploy troops during the ceasefire, that they are both positioning their forces to maximize advantage for reacting if the ceasefire falls. Still, the momentum seems to be that the ceasefire is holding for now.
For over 35 years, Roberts & Roberts has been a trusted source for buying and selling your investment-grade precious metals. They also take Bitcoin for precious metal purchases and permanently removed the minimum purchase order for all orders paid in the digital currency. Call Roberts & Roberts today for knowledgeable advice on investing and a forward-thinking approach to new technologies. 850-478-5270 or online at rrbi.co.
Reuters reports the United States is considering slowing a planned withdrawal of U.S. troops from Afghanistan to ensure that progress sticks after more than a decade of war. Under current plan, the United States will cut in half the number of troops in Afghanistan to just over 5,000 this year, gradually winding down to a normal U.S. embassy presence by the end of 2016. That schedule could now change, at least in part, according to new Defense Secretary Ash Carter on his first trip abroad since swearing in as the Pentagon chief on Tuesday, as the United States also rethinks the future of its counterterrorism mission in Afghanistan. His remarks set the stage for talks next month when the Afghan president is expected in Washington. Ghani said he expected to discuss U.S. troop numbers with Obama in the context of the larger partnership.
FPP Radio News is brought to you by Coinbase. Coinbase is a simple and secure online Bitcoin wallet for sending, receiving, and storing Bitcoin. Coinbase also allows you to buy and sell Bitcoin using a bank account or use their tools to accept Bitcoin as a merchant. Opening a wallet is quick and easy, and for merchants, there are no transaction fees on the first $1 million worth of transactions. Get started at coinbase.fppradio.com. UPI reports several Republican governors are urging GOP congressional leaders to stand firm next week in opposing legislation funding the Department of Homeland Security if it does not overturn President Barack Obama's executive action on immigration. Governors in both parties meeting in Washington this weekend warned of economic and security concerns should Congress fail to resolve its latest budget standoff. The agency's $40 billion budget runs out February 26th, giving federal lawmakers only a few days to reach an agreement once they return from recess next week. Oklahoma Governor Mary Fallon said Homeland Security funding is very important not only to our nation, but to our individual states because of our military installations, especially at a time that there are so many threats around the world with the Islamic State and other terrorist groups. We hope that Congress will be able to find a resolution to get DHS funding passed, but we also know that there are concerns and questions about immigration and the president's powers. While some call for compromise, a handful of high-profile Republicans charged that stopping what they see as Obama's unconstitutional power grab may be as important as resolving the funding dispute. The Obama administration last week put on hold plans to shield more than 4 million immigrants living in the country from deportation after a federal judge in Texas temporarily blocked the effort the day the program was scheduled to begin. 26 states, led by Texas, filed suit in December, arguing that the president does not have the authority to allow groups of immigrants to legally stay and work in the United States. The White House is appealing the ruling. This has been FPP Radio News, online at fppradio.com.
A fully leveled up video game character marvels at how far he's come, and the milk rushing through a jug handle is having the time of its life. This is The Onion Week in Review. This week, top executives from the U.S. financial sector announced they're about ready to ruin the world again. Representatives from all major banking and investment institutions said that more than enough time has passed since they last caused a major global economic meltdown, and confirmed they're pretty much fully prepared to bring about a brand new worldwide financial crisis.
We feel like we've given people enough time to get comfortable again. Consumer spending is increased. Housing market has rebounded. So yeah, we're all set to go ahead and ruin the global economy again.
And in other news, the perfect gift for a local man is unfortunately a gift certificate to Lowe's Cinemas. Mall shoppers look on in awe as a helpless 15-year-old girl is viciously torn apart by a pack of her peers. And a drunk pilot decides to pull over onto a cloud until he sobers up. You will now hear three gong strikes and a recitation of the great chant before being ushered to the hallowed garden. For more, keep checking theonion.com.
This is the Onion News Network.
Free Talk Live. Dial toll-free here and bring up whatever you'd like. The toll-free number is 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733. We're talking about terrorism. Domestic so-called terrorism. And I say so-called because I don't really consider the sovereign citizen guys to be terrorists. Some of them are dangerous, but they're not actually actively trying to, like, destroy police departments or anything like that.
There was that group that was looking to do some bombing. There's been a couple of groups that were sort of looking to do some aggressive bombings. They got infiltrated and taken down.
Were they sovereign citizens?
I got the impression they were sort of sovereign-y. They were sort of right-wingy.
When was this? I don't recall the
story. Okay, there was the ones in Alaska, and
they wanted to allegedly kill a judge or some cops or whatever.
That's pretty terrorist-y, right?
Yeah, I don't know if they were sovereign citizens. I guess they kind of might
have.
You could have probably qualified them.
Yeah, they're going to get lumped into that category if they're sort of right-wingy, right-wingy.
But to be clear, they were also infiltrated by the feds, and you know they were ginning up the killing idea.
Indeed, but I'm just saying that's the kind of rebuttal that you're going to get in that. Also, there was, I think they were sort of in Indiana or Pennsylvania or West Virginia or something, was another group that was infiltrated, and the feds, of course, were willing to arm them and, you know, send them on their ways. And once they said, oh, yeah, that sounds like a good idea, they swooped in and arrested them. Now, it's interesting.
Yeah. I mean, I don't consider it, if what it takes is a federal agent to go undercover to gin up violence, if that's what it takes to actually, you know, make some violence happen, I don't really consider that to be legitimate, because you can argue that had the federal agent not come in and talked about violence and encouraged violence and offered weapons for violence and offered funding for violence, then you could make an argument that the violence never would have occurred.
Certainly, you could make that argument.
That people never would have come to that conclusion had that federal agent not come in and suggested it in the first place.
But McVeigh certainly came to fruition without the Fed's help, right?
Was he a sovereign citizen?
He
was an ex-military guy.
He would be sort of a proto-sovereign citizen. He was along that line.
He was trained by the military, though.
Yeah, McVeigh, there's plenty of sovereign citizens that are ex-military, Ian.
Well, that's the thing,
it's not like
Mark,
he was on a mission from the Pentagon.
I think you're really, reaching here to try to make it sound like the sovereign citizen movement, if you can even call it that, is some group of violent extremists.
I'm not reaching. I have said already, I've been very, very clear that if you line up the innocent people killed by the police over the course of the last decade, and you line up the police that have been killed by sovereign citizens, and that's just assuming every police officer was killed by sovereign citizens, didn't deserve it, and I don't think they did, then you will find that just statistically, since the police killed 1,100 people last year, they must have been wrong some percentage of the time. If they were wrong 1% of the time, they killed 11 innocent people. I wish that I was only wrong 1% of the time. I would have I'd be really, really great at my job. So 11 innocent people, that's just, you know, some back of the napkin numbers here, were killed last year by police. There haven't been 11 police killed by sovereign citizens. So if you're going to organizations as far as sort of their danger to the public, mm-hmm. police would come up higher than sovereign citizens. I've been 100% sure. clear on that. But to say that an organization, a very loose group of people that's willing to use violence to defend
only
themselves
some of them
in sort of
remember the claim is there
fantastic scenarios. Yeah, I think that's going to fit a loose definition of terrorism, terrorists.
No, it by no way defines what terrorism is, because the sovereign citizens just want to be left alone, and they usually are using violence in defense of their lifestyle and defense of being able to be left alone. Again, I'm not saying I support their violence, but I don't think that's by definition terrorism. Also, the Southern Poverty Law Center claims that by some estimates there are as many as 300,000 people involved in some way with sovereign citizen extremism. Perhaps 100,000 people form a core of the movement, he said. But as you said, Mark, this is a loose affiliation at best. You know, you can go ahead and consider yourself to be a sovereign citizen without having to sign up for anything or, you know, join some sort of group or militia or whatever. And I haven't even gone off on, you know, why it is I think the term's ridiculous. Sovereign citizen, sovereign is by definition, a king. You know, if you are a sovereign, you are the king of your own domain. And you can therefore not, by definition, be a citizen and a king at the same time. So it just doesn't make any sense. You know, the definition of citizen is one who owes a duty of allegiance in return for an obligation of protection, usually from the sovereign. It's just a contradiction in terms, and really makes me question how much thought these people have really put into this. But, you know, just like with people who are of the Islam belief system, the sovereign citizen belief system has allegedly hundreds of thousands of adherents, but yet only a handful of violent incidents.
Yes.
So it's also not fair to paint the so-called sovereign citizens as necessarily being having a proclivity towards violence.
That you know, that benefits the state to do that, right? Like
sure.
The state is an organization that without threats, without you know, real palpable threats, you know, your feel, I shouldn't say real, but your sort of perceived palpable threats can't exist. This is one of the reasons I believe they go around the world and gin up problems. Because if somebody doesn't gin up the problems, then there's not the threats. And you don't need as many of these enforcers in place at any given time. Now, their argument would be that when you need the enforcers, you need them. And you know, the public tends not to you know, they underestimate their need for the enforcers at any given time, so we have to sort of make the threats more real to them.
A survey of last year of state and local law enforcement officers listed sovereign citizen terrorists ahead of foreign Islamists and domestic militia groups as the top domestic terror threat. The survey was conducted by the University of Maryland's National Consortium for the Study of Terrorism and Responses to Terrorism. In 2013, a man who held anti-government views carried out a shooting attack on three Transportation Security Administration employees at Los Angeles International Airport, killing one TSA officer. Last year, a couple killed two police officers and a bystander at a Las Vegas Walmart store. Mark Protok, the senior fellow at the Southern Poverty Law Center, estimates, again, that 300,000 people are involved in some way with so-called sovereign citizen extremism. And Protok says that the federal government's focus on the domestic groups waxes and wanes, in part because the threat from foreign groups like Al-Qaeda and its affiliates. Potok says says sovereign citizen groups have attracted support because of poor economic conditions. Some groups travel the country pitching their ideology as a way to help homeowners escape foreclosure and or get out of debt by simply ignoring the courts and bankruptcy law. And this is one of the dangerous areas of this so-called sovereign citizen movement. There are sort of different prongs to it. There's the kind of the prong of, well, you know, the police don't own you and you don't have to respect their so-called authority. And then there's also this other prong of, oh, well, the contract you signed to get the loan was really you're creating money out of thin air. And so therefore, it's just a bunch of nonsense in the first place. So why bother paying back the mortgage? Or if you sign the mortgage papers with this particular phrase, then that will somehow exempt you from having to be liable for paying. I mean, there's just there are these theories within the sovereign citizen movement that essentially try to get people out of financial obligations. And so there are people who are attracted to it for different reasons. So someone who's attracted to the so-called sovereign movement because they don't want to pay their mortgage is a different kind of person than the person who's attracted because they, you know, they don't respect the police's so-called authority. And there's definitely crossover between the two areas, but they're, to me, very distinct sections of this particular movement.
Yeah, I think that if you sign a document that says you're going to pay for something that, you know, that's your word. Now, I understand we work in a rigged system where the banks don't have the same skin in the game that the rest of us do. They lie and they, you know, fake signatures and they do a variety of things. But I still think that when you say you're going to pay for something, you should pay for that thing.
Yeah, I totally agree with that. And I think that's something that can get people in some hot water as well. I mean, thinking that they can just put some sort of text on their check or whatever and or the invoice and that it'll somehow be paid from some mystical secretive bank account that's attached to your social security number because the government is actually selling your corporation on the black market or there's just some I'm not recounting it accurately, but there's all kinds of conspiracy theory that surrounds this sovereign citizen movement. 855-450-FREE is the toll-free number. Are you afraid of the sovereign citizens? It's Free Talk Live.
Shiny badges on your jacket, shiny badges.
This is Davi Barker from shinybadges.com, and I just want to personally apologize for airing a jingle week after week, month after month, that turned out to be such an infectious brain worm. So to make it up to you, I'm offering a free gift. The next time you make a purchase at shinybadges.com, write worms in the transaction comments, and I'll send you something weird.
Free Talk Live has partnered with Amazon, the largest internet retailer. Imagine a department store category, and Amazon has it. Books, electronics, office products, furniture, jewelry, automotive, toys, clothing, sporting goods, and dozens of other categories. Now you can shop and support Free Talk Live by entering Amazon through our website. Go to shop.freetalklive.com, and Amazon will send us a portion of your purchase. You're going to do the shopping anyway, so remember to enter through our site at shop.freetalklive.com. That's shop.freetalklive.com.
Again, the Congressional Budget Office sounds the alarm. This time warns of Greek-style U.S. debt crises. You heard me right. The GAO is drawing a parallel between the U.S. economy, its debt, and the current Greek economic meltdown. With the debt-to-GDP chart climbing into unfamiliar territory, the growing budget deficit will rise to unsupportable levels. Hi, this is Ted Anderson. The Federal Debt and Risk of Financial Crises document the CBO has published is a must-read for every American. Covering the risk of continued deficit spending coupled with an aging population and the rising interest rates spell economic disaster. It's imperative that you get a copy of this document and study it for yourself. Call me today at 800-686-2237, and I'll send you a free copy. Again, call 800-686-2237 and ask for your copy of the CBO document. Once again, you need to read this government report. Call 800-686-2237.
So the protection of life, liberty, and property is what the Free State Project is all about. But it's an effort to move 20,000 people who understand.
It's about demonstrating to the entire country
that, yeah, we can have a free market, a truly free market.
Making it just a freer, great place to live.
It's the world's largest voluntarist libertarian community, and it's only getting bigger.
That's amazing, to be able to move to a place where other people like passionately believe in being free and independent.
What the Free State Project is managing to do, though, is to put their money where their mouth is. Physically getting up across the country and saying, let's go someplace and let's demonstrate the power of these ideas. There's a lot of kind of philosophy that surrounds liberty. There's a lot of thinking about it and talking about it. But here in New Hampshire, people are doing it.
101 Reasons Liberty Lives in New Hampshire, a documentary by Free State Project Early Movers. Watch it free at 101reasonsfilm.com. 101reasonsfilm.com. If you want to know the latest about Free Talk Live before we go on the air, all you need to decide is how you want it delivered. It's your choice. Visit news.freetalklive.com. You can get emailed announcements and participate in contests via our email updates list. Plus, we have a Twitter account that you can follow and a Facebook page where you can become a fan. So visit news.freetalklive.com to get news about Free Talk Live as soon as it's announced and the way you want it delivered at news.freetalklive.com. That's news.freetalklive.com.
If you want to move to the Free State and you're looking for some real estate, well, I know a guy who's really great. It's the realtor Mark Warden. Do you want a home with 20 acres, a lakeside cabin, any takers for renters, buyers, and sellers too? Mark Warden is the guy for you. PorcupineRealEstate.com.
Help get LRN.FM into more ears. Visit promote.lrn.fm for a free bumper sticker, flyers, banners, graphics, and more. Promote.lrn.fm.
Free Talk Live, you dial toll-free, 855-450-FREE is the number. That's 855-450-3733. We've got Skype as well. Our Skype username is lrn.fm. The live Sunday edition continues here. We've been talking about the so-called sovereign citizen movement. They're back in the news with CNN examining a Department of Homeland Security report that is once again trotting out the so-called sovereign citizens as something to be afraid of, a domestic terrorist extremist threat. These are some of the words that are being bandied about in the story. You're welcome to share your thoughts with us. Maybe you consider yourself a sovereign citizen. You're welcome to call in toll free at 855-450-FREE. Personally, I like the idea of being sovereign. I don't like the idea of being a citizen. And I don't understand how someone can be the two things at once.
Yeah, they really are contrary terminology. I mean, you're either a sovereign or you're a citizen of a sovereign, but you can't be both.
Yeah, if you consider yourself to be a sovereign citizen, to me, that means you haven't really thought it through that much. The toll-free number is 855-450-FREE. Let's go to your calls and thoughts here. Dave is in Poughkeepsie, New York. You're on Free Talk Live. Dave.
Hi, guys. How you doing?
Dave, go ahead with your thoughts.
My county executive person, I don't know if I should, can I mention his name?
Doesn't really matter.
Yeah, okay. His name is Marcus Molinaro, and I've been talking with him on Twitter, and he is a real big moron, okay? Now, I don't know if you guys
strong
will have
snow
up on your... Yes, he is. That is a strong claim, because down here in the Hudson Valley, we have a thing called the Dutchess Rail Trail. Now, this thing is not plowed at all. I guess maybe you don't have the funds for it, whatever, or something. He says, oh, it's a national park. But they can plow the walkway over the Hudson, but they don't want to plow the Dutchess Rail Trail. What if somebody needs to get some? Because I had to walk on a couple of days ago to get someplace, and I ruined a good pair of boots.
Let me ask you this. Usually on these rails to trails, they've got snowmobiles that are going and packing down the snow. Is there snowmobiles going along it?
No, there isn't. Nobody is plowing these Dutchess rail trails. Okay. And I keep asking him.
Let me see if I'm clear on this here. So this is a government trail that it travels around the Poughkeepsie area. Is that right?
It goes from Hopewell Junction all the way over to Highland.
I don't know where any of that is. Is that in Poughkeepsie?
No, Hopewell Junction is way down south. It's another because there's little towns. There's Hopewell, Beacon, Newburgh.
So you contacted the county representative. What is he?
Marcus Molinaro. He's a county executive.
Okay, and so what is that? Is that somebody who is an elected position, or is it like a city manager kind of person?
It would be like any other county executive, like you guys have up in Keene, New Hampshire.
Do they normally plow this, and they just didn't plow it this year, or what's the deal?
No, they never plow it. They only want to plow the walkway over the Hudson. They don't plow the Dutchess Rail Trail, and it pisses me off.
So you've contacted this guy to complain about it and demand that, as a tax-paying person, I believe you should be plowing this trail. And what has he said to you? What has been his response?
Well, I'm reading his Twitter right now. It says, "Oh, I'm terribly sorry. It's a trail. We do not have the ability to plow it. We will consider your concerns for next year. Oh, I'm sorry. It's a county park, and we do not plow it. We will take your concerns into mind and consider it for next year. It's a policy decision we can consider for next winter, but we do not plow the Dutchess Rail Trail."
Yeah.
And he says, "Oh, I asked him why they actually can't do it." It says,
You're a little bit muffled there, Dave, but I can understand the frustration. I mean, people expect the government to provide certain services, and one of those services is kind of the basic of, you know, clearing the roads. And I guess clearing the trails, people who walk around kind of might have that expectation that they're going to take care of the
trails. They may or may not have that expectation. It's just that, funds are limited. The question I'd have for you, Ian, is how much of the taxpayers' money should be put towards clearing this, because it doesn't get cleared for free, right? Like, you have to have equipment and you have to have people.
I just want to see it plowed, because
do you have a shovel?
If I need to go somewhere, I'm not plowing it all the way from Hopewell all the way over to Highland.
Apparently they aren't either.
Neither are they.
Thanks, Dave, for the call tonight. But I can understand the frustration. Mark, I'm not saying one way or another how I feel like that should be handled. I think that a basic expectation of government is to allow people to travel on the roads. There's a similar expectation,
I
think, that people who walk places have, that the government
will. This is a park, not a walkway so much, right? Like, this is a county park.
Is it?
He may be talking to the wrong person, mind you, because this is a city executive, right? A Poughkeepsie, not a county.
No, he's a county executive.
Okay, fine. Then he's in the right ballpark, at least.
He's blowing him off. I mean, he's saying, look.
He's blowing him off.
We'll look at it next year. That's a lie. He's not going to look at it next year.
They'll look at it next year, and they'll probably make the same decision that they made the last year.
They're not going to look at it.
Okay, so the problem is it's a sort of the public property issue, right? He wants public property. Dave wants public property treated in one way, and this county commissioner is dealing with his realities, and his reality says he doesn't have the budget to do it, because believe me, if he had unlimited budgets, he'd plow everything. He's just going to take all the money he can get and plow all the stuff.
Well, because I don't believe it, Mark. This is New York, and they've got big, big budgets in New York, and I'm sure there's all kinds of money being funneled into a bunch of nonsense.
Sure.
That some of that money could very easily be used to plow a trail.
Oh, I didn't claim that he was going to reallocate funds from the other things to this. He would be happy, however, to take more funds and plow more stuff. They'd be happy to do that. Governments do that all the time.
I think they love make work programs. They prefer to take more funds and do nothing.
Okay, fine. Yeah. But, that being said, it's difficult for them to pass that off.
Let's go to Dan. He's listening in Iowa. Dan, you're on Free Talk Live with Ian and Mark.
Hello, first Dan. Time listener here.
Welcome, sir.
Probably kind of came in on your conversation a little late, but I heard the term sovereign citizen thrown around. I always thought I paid pretty good attention to some stuff and liked to be informed, but I was just wondering, is that a term called the DHS or the Southern Province Bus Center? What's the issue with that?
You're asking where it came from?
Yes, I've never heard it before, and I know the issue you're talking about.
We've got a really bad connection, Daniel. We're unfortunately losing every other word of what you're saying. Is it that you are wondering where the origin of the term is, where it came from?
Origin and criteria. Yeah, that'd be great. I'm sorry about the connection.
The criteria, when you say that, what do you mean?
Well, define it.
I know I've heard the term right-wing extremist. It seems like anyone who believes in the Constitution these days like they fall like that.
Yeah, I think that's a legitimate concern. And Dan, I thank you for the call tonight. We'll address the call off the air or address you after you're off the air. But yeah, I think that there is a legitimate concern there. And there were some documents that came out, if you recall, during the Bush administration, some Homeland Security documents saying that if somebody's got a copy of the Constitution with them in the car, then that's an indicator that this might be a domestic terrorist. So they've definitely tried to tie people who believe in the Constitution with the idea of so-called terrorism. The sovereign citizen term, you know, I don't know where it came from.
Says here in Wikipedia, the concept of a sovereign citizen originated with the Posse Comitatus movement as a teaching of Christian identity minister William P. Gale. The Posse Comitatus movement, which I then looked up.
Hold on. We'll come back here. 855-450-FREE. 855-450-3733. It's Free Talk Live.
It's no secret that government and big business buy in bulk and get huge discounts not available to the little guy. Until now. Introducing a breakthrough crowd buying website where people can join together, buy in bulk, and get massive discounts on millions of popular products. It's TogetherSave.com. TogetherSave.com. You can save 20, 30, or even 50% off tablets, smartphones, cars, appliances, textbooks, sports equipment, video games, and much more. All with free delivery. Check it out. TogetherSave.com. Visit now and start group buying today at TogetherSave.com.
We love that you're passionate about GCN. And whether you're a listener, a business owner, or a radio industry professional, we've redesigned the new GCN newsletter to keep you in the know. Get updates on your favorite GCN shows and hosts. Go to GCNlive.com and click on the banner in the upper left corner. Just for signing up, you're automatically entered for monthly giveaways. Start receiving your newsletter today. The future of talk radio. GCN.
When commercials come on, don't push the button. Instead, listen. Even if you don't sell things for a living, you're still selling in the various conversations and transactions that make up your busy day. With money and attention so scarce now, effective communication skills have never been more important, especially if you're a job seeker. So take a lesson from Madison Avenue. Often the fewer words, the more effective the message. Like Jiffy Lube, where you never need an appointment, or the Office Max ad that says, "You supply the ambition, we supply everything else." How about online ticket broker StubHub.com, the way in when it's sold out, or CyberCupid Match.com's seductive, "Go ahead, it's okay to look." How cleverly and succinctly can you distill your message? For more tips, hit SurvivalSpeech.com. I'm Holland Cook.
Aren't you tired of governments murdering people around the world? Well, stop using their money. There's an alternative. Bitcoin is a stateless, free market, non-political currency. Bitcoin cannot be inflated or controlled by any government. And by using their money, you're helping the state. Stop doing it. You have an incredible alternative available now. Learn it. Use it. Spread it. Get started with Bitcoin at weusecoins.com. That's weusecoins.com.
Here's a chance to do a little activism while you're cruising Facebook, Twitter, or Google+. Between the LOL cats, the recipes, the hot girls, and the inspirational sunrise memes, Free Talk Live's post pass by your newsfeed. Like them. Comment. It gives us more exposure. If you don't see our posts, click like at facebook.freetalklive.com and then hover over it to click get notifications. It's an easy way to spread the ideas of liberty a bit further. I know you're busy, but you can spare that tenth of a calorie it takes to click on something. Facebook.freetalklive.com.
Free Talk Live.
Pushing woman to the ground with a camera in her hand, you know, yeah. I think a real man wouldn't do that. And you got to be on roids or something to get into that state of
mind.
Well,
Wayne hit it on the head. If they're not on steroids, and a number of them, some of them are, most of them probably aren't. They're not on steroids, maybe, but they're definitely high on adrenaline. Former drug task force officer, when he started with the police, you know, he would get that adrenaline rush from writing a ticket. And then, of course, he acclimated himself to it, and then he needed something else. He needed to escalate. He needed to have something else. So it got so extreme that he would leave people uncuffed. Like he'd bust a Coke dealer or something like that, mm-hmm. and then just leave them uncuffed on the hopes that they would get up and try to run.
So he'd kick some butt.
Right. Exactly. Yeah.
Free Talk Live, 7 nights a week from 7 to 10 Eastern, live on the Liberty Radio Network at LRN.FM.
This is the Liberty Radio Network, broadcasting the latest liberty-oriented audio content 24 hours a day at LRN.fm.
Free Talk Live, you can dial in toll-free to join us here and bring up whatever you would like at 855-450-FREE, 855-450-3733. Join us on Skype. Our Skype username is lrn.fm. You send a contact request, we'll approve it. Just did that for a guy that just, or guy or gal, don't know. Somebody with an indeterminate name has sent a contact request. It has been approved, just as yours will be. If you send it to lrn.fm on Skype, vegas.com. That's where you can go to get the best rates on not just hotels in Vegas, but also headliner shows, tours, attractions, and VIP bottle service at top clubs. Vegas.com is the way to book Vegas. They serve up Vegas from the inside because, unlike so many other travel sites, at Vegas.com, they're from Vegas. The people that work at Vegas.com live in Vegas, they work in Vegas, and they party in Vegas. They know the people that set the deals, so the second prices drop in Vegas, Vegas.com drops them on their site in real time. Plus, with their proprietary drop watch tool, you will continue to get the best price. They'll monitor it even after you book and notify you of changes to ensure you get the best deal. You book at the lower rate and they'll refund you the difference. Vegas.com. They do the work for you and they've got your back at Vegas.com. Use code FTL, by the way, when you're checking out at Vegas.com to save 10%, even more. You will save even more by using our code FTL at checkout. And by the way, that works for everything on the site with the exception of the air hotel packages. So if it's got air involved in it, it's not going to get the 10% off. But otherwise, you get 10% off pretty much everything over at Vegas.com with code FTL. Let's continue here. We can talk more about the sovereign citizen term, its origins here in a moment. I know, Mark, you'd pulled up some info on that. But first, Keith is with us in Iowa. Hello, Keith.
Yeah. Hello. Welcome. I'd like to pass the word along to that guy in Poughkeepsie. Those rails to trails are actually private property. They're still owned by the railroad companies, and the reason why they convert them to trails is so that they, when they, if there's ever a resurgence in the trail in the railroads, they still have the land, and they all they have to do is tear up the asphalt if there's any asphalt. Drop their ballast and then put in their ties and their rails. My brother-in-law used to work for the railroad. He told me about those, and we were, I thought it was kind of an ingenious thing myself.
Yeah, I think it's a great idea if they just sort of keep the right of way, as it were, and they allow people to use it because they're near my house. There's some rails to trails, and the snowmobiles, they call themselves the snow belters up here. They pay to maintain it. I mean, I know the railroad doesn't pay to maintain it. So basically, people are paying to maintain this land, but the railroads can go back and get it. I'll bet that's true.
Yep. Y'all have a good one.
Thanks for sharing that, Keith. Appreciate the info. Toll-free number is 855-450-FREE. So, Mark, you had pulled up. There was a question that a caller earlier had asked about. Didn't have a good cell phone connection, but we basically ferreted out that he wanted to know what the origins of this term sovereign citizen are.
Right.
Was it something created by the government, the Department of Homeland Security, or something else?
According to this, the concept of a sovereign citizen originated in the Posse Comitatus movement as a teaching of Christian Identity Minister William P. Gale. The concept has influenced the tax protester movement, the Christian patriot movement, and the redemption movement, the last of which claims the U.S. government uses its citizens as collateral against foreign debt. To some extent, I believe it does use its citizens as collateral against foreign debt. I just don't think it's formalized.
Well, the redemption people, I'm glad you used that term because I didn't remember what they were called. But that was the aspect of the so-called sovereign citizens that I was describing earlier, where they believe that by signing an invoice in a certain way that, I forget what it all I'm spacing on what the actual terms
is. Under duress,
No, it's not under duress. It's like, I don't know. I'm not even going to try to take a shot in the dark at it. But some sort of sovereign citizen-y phrase, they put it on there, and that it somehow will pay the invoice from some secretive account that the government is holding under their social security number based on their birth certificate, because the government actually has all this money that they've socked away in secretive accounts. And it's just a crazy scheme that gets people to believe that they can actually somehow get these bills that they have, whether it's their mortgage or car loan, get them paid off by simply writing something down on the invoice. And it'll get you charged with fraud is what'll happen.
I don't believe that for a second, but I do believe that the government uses you as collateral to pay foreign and domestic debts. The Federal Reserve is the lender of last resort, and mostly that's who's buying up the federal government's debt at this point. But essentially, what are they saying? When they run up a debt, what are they saying? They're saying that we'll get the tax money to pay this. Well, where are they going to get the tax money? They get the tax money from your income, the fruits of your labor. And that essentially makes you their property. If you can take the fruits of somebody's labor and assign them away from them, that you essentially hold them as a slave. Now, I'm not claiming that you hold them like chattel slavery from the antebellum South. I think that clearly that was worse. But what you have to realize is that every slave that a slave master had in the South cost them money. They didn't get 100% of the fruits of their labor. They had to spend money on, housing them and feeding them and medical care and all the other things that that would go into keeping somebody who on your property that you didn't pay to do things. So, I mean, obviously, it worked as a concept. Many people didn't believe that you could the cotton industry would continue without slavery. They were wrong. And as a matter of fact, cotton's, just fine. We can do just fine without that sort of slavery. But I'd say we can do with just fine without the other sorts of slavery, too. So if you – let's say it costs that a slave costs what – 80% of their labor – the 20% of their labor has to go back into feeding, housing, and clothing them. Because they probably don't work as hard as a free man. It'd be just my guess. Then, they take 80% of the fruits of their labor and reassign it elsewhere. And they can't leave. Well, here in the United States, they take, on average, 35% of the fruits of your labor. Some people would estimate that higher on up into 60%. I've heard arguments for and against, and I wouldn't be able to. I'm not going to take a position. But let's say it's 35%. Well, if you can take 80%, and if you can take 35%, you can take whatever percent you want. There's lots of politicians that want more taken. Mm-hmm. And you can leave, but you got to pay an exit tax. You got to ask permission. You have to have their passport. I mean, slaves were able to leave the plantation all the time with their master's permission. They'd carry money with their master's permission. There's all kinds of rules out there. So I think that there's many parallels between citizenship and slavery.
So, by the way, Chris Cantwell is listening, and he sent the term that I was scraping for earlier. It's called accepted for value.
Oh, accepted for value.
That's what the claim is. If you write that on an invoice or something like that, that it'll be magically paid. And actually, there's a website here, rationalwiki.org, that has a page about this so-called redemption movement. A little bit of story for you here. It's a pseudo-legal conspiracy theory marketed as a debt elimination scam. It holds that when the U.S. government abandoned the gold standard in 1933, it pledged its citizens as collateral in place of the gold to support the currency. The attractive bit is the claim that you can redeem your birth bond for free money. Actually, putting any of this into practice gets you fined or put into jail. The notion originated in the U.S. with white supremacist Roger Elvick, who pushed it through the early 1980s and 90s. He went to jail, of course. The idea is most of the source of the so-called straw man theory, and despite the name, it has nothing to do with Christianity. Elvick believed that the government deposits exactly $630,000 into a hidden bank account linked to the newborn American and administered by a Jewish cabal. Its promoters claim...
it's always the Jews.
Well, he is a white supremacist. Its promoters claim that if you complete the correct magic legal maneuvers, you can avail yourself of the $630,000 held in the name of your doppelganger persona, and that after filing the correct paperwork at the courthouse declaring one a sovereign citizen, one's home loans and other debts can be paid in full by tendering a site draft or a bill of exchange in the name of the U.S. Treasury. And so, yeah, if you're going to go through any of this stuff, you're likely going to attract way more attention from the government than you really wanted to have.
It does say here that some sovereign citizens actually consider the term an oxymoron and use the term sovereign individual seeking the truth. I like that one better.
Yeah, there you go. Toll-free number 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733. There's more Free Talk Live coming up.
Here's a special message for those of you who owe the IRS at least $10,000 or more in back taxes. The IRS has special programs in place that could eliminate or reduce your tax debt by thousands of dollars. Call the tax helpline that has been set up to help you. 800-691-6129. That's 800-691-6129. Stop the wage garnishments, levies, and tax liens now. Once you've qualified and enrolled, the IRS will stop all the collection activities against you. These unique programs have been allocated to help the economy and significantly reduce or eliminate your tax burden. The IRS is currently accepting reduced settlements and other favorable programs. You may qualify for substantial savings, so get the help you need. For free information and to see if you qualify, take down the number now for the Tax Representation Hotline. 800-691-6129. That's 800-691-6129. 800-691-6129.
Hunters, anglers, campers, and survivalists. Get back to nature. Expand your horizons with the highest quality, most versatile, unique slingshots and slingbows on the market at slingbow.com. Slingbow products are compact and models start from just $17.98. They're perfect for your bug out bag or storing in your vehicle. Give yourself and your loved ones the excitement and tradition of slingbow. A new frontier in archery and truly modern twist on this primitive survival tool. Feel the thrill only at slingbow.com.
This is David Cordani, CEO of Cigna. For more than 20 years, Cigna has worked with the March of Dimes to address premature births in the U.S. Thank you for taking time to learn more about how you could support March for Babies in 2015. Premature births cause horrible suffering and cost billions of dollars each year. That's why Cigna is committed to raising funds and awareness through our employees, family, and friends to improve the health of moms and babies. Please join us in supporting the March for Babies. Start your team today at marchforbabies.org.
I've been told no in many different ways.
I give you an order and you're going to obey it.
Who told you to go this way?
You can't do that and you have to leave here.
You cannot bring signs into their rally.
Walk with me.
Well, I'm comfortable here, actually.
Whoa, excuse me.
Who do you think you are?
Excuse me.
There is no video or audio allowed in this office.
No, I have work today. This is...
You ain't going to make it.
Wait
on account.
Now.
Wait a minute.
Hey! Oh my God! Unbelievable!
Why are you running from me?
Because you're scared of me!
Property.
What am I being detained for?
You're being served.
What is this?
You're being served.
What is this?
Bureaucrats have a funny way of telling people no.
That's the sound of the men working on the chain.
Derek J's Victimless Crime Spree. Watch it for free and order the Director's Cut DVD at victimlesscrimespree.com. So you've heard all 3 hours of the latest episode of Free Talk Live, and you're still hungry for liberty-oriented audio content? Did you know that we have another 24/7 audio stream at LRN.fm? The Liberty Radio Network airs the latest episodes of some of the best liberty-oriented podcasts on the internet, around the clock. In addition to recorded content, you'll also hear live shows like Free Talk Live, originating from our Keene, New Hampshire studio. So listen anytime at LRN.fm. That's LRN.fm.
Liberty activists around the country are starting to realize politics alone won't set us free. So what will? At Liberty on the Rocks, we believe the answer starts with living your principles, spreading ideas, and connecting with those around you. By starting a Liberty on the Rocks network, you can make a difference by uniting libertarian thinkers. Find out how much fun it is to build your local network from the ground up. Visit libertyontherocks.org today to get started.
You can sign up to receive the latest about the Liberty Radio Network via our email updates at updates.lrn.fm. That's updates.lrn.fm.
It's Free Talk Live, and you can dial toll-free here. 855-450-FREE is the number. That's 855-450-3733. with you tonight in studio. It's me, Ian.
And me, Mark.
And you can join us online. Just drop by freetalklive.com. Enjoy the features we have waiting for you there. And, of course, you can go and get Bitcoin from our friends at ExpressCoin.com.
Yeah, ExpressCoin makes it easy for you. It's safe, fast, and inexpensive. They're a licensed money services business, so you know everything's on the up and up with ExpressCoin.com. You can get Bitcoins, Litecoin, some other cryptocurrencies over there, Dogecoin, as a matter of fact. It's just you just start off at ExpressCoin.com, whether you're in the U.S. or Canada. You can even do it from your phone. They've got an app there. You use a money order or a check to get Bitcoins or whatever your cryptocurrency is. And if you use coupon code FTL, you can get up to $40 worth of the cryptocurrency you choose with no fee at all. So they have a little fee that, of course, they've got to run a business here, right? They're selling you Bitcoins and Dogecoin and Litecoin and other cryptocurrencies. Mm-hmm. But they'll waive that fee if you get under $40 worth and you use the coupon code FTL at ExpressCoin.com.
I've done it. It's a darn fine idea.
Me too.
So ExpressCoin.com. Our toll-free number tonight, again, 855-450-FREE. We've been talking about the so-called sovereign citizens and that the Department of Homeland Security is trotting them out as a big threat, claiming that there have been 24 violent so-called sovereign citizen-related attacks across the United States since 2010, although I suspect that the term related is likely a very wide-open term, meaning that someone who was involved in some kind of an attack might have a family member who was a sovereign citizen. I mean, we've seen this kind of these stretches going on with the government police where they will label, like I said before, like somebody if they get into a car wreck and the driver is not drunk, but the passenger is drunk. That is an alcohol-related offense. I think that it's true that some people within the sovereign citizen movement are likely to use violence, but I think that's true within the libertarian movement as well. I think that's true within the Republicans and the Democrats. I think there are people out there who are, you know, they're desperate.
That's what happens. This is desperation is what it's about, is people feel a threat, and that's what politics is. Politics is essentially a threat. And they feel the threat on themselves, and they react as though they've been threatened. And that's that.
Except, as we pointed out, when it's the police that you're using violence against, no one will see it as legitimate. Even though I can understand it, I don't agree with it as a tactic, but I am in the, you know, minority of people, the very, very small minority of people who could possibly even empathize with people in these circumstances who are using violence to defend against the aggression of the government police.
Mm-hmm.
I can see that crystal clear, but even I know that it's a bad idea and that it's not going to advance the ideas of freedom, which, by the way, the sovereign citizens don't necessarily believe in. I'd like to make that clear. A so-called sovereign citizen is not someone who has a particular political ideology. They're just somebody who doesn't want the government messing with them, generally. They want to be left alone unless they're part of this redemption movement and then they're trying to scam people out of money. But the aspect of the sovereign citizens who just, you know, hey, I don't believe in your authority, that doesn't mean that they're liberty-minded. That just means they don't believe in the authority of the government. So I can share that belief. I also don't believe in the authority of the government agents. To me, they're all human beings, and the police are men, you know, and women who are willing to use violence to get their way.
Yeah,
and they have legitimacy about them.
Well, perceived legitimacy, but
it's perceived by the other people, right? Like they believe they have legitimacy, and so do a lot of other people.
It's interesting how many organizations, the Southern Poverty Law Center comes to mind, consider sort of the sovereign citizens to be this giant threat. The Southern Poverty Law Center put out a video about them at one point. But the Southern Poverty Law Center was originally instituted to protect black people against government aggression.
Huh.
And they've essentially been
co-opted
by that, in that way. And now they, if there's 1,100 people killed in 2014, many of them are going to be people of color and by the police, and some of those people are clearly innocent. You'd think the Southern Poverty Law Center would be concerned with that.
You know,
but instead, they're all worried about the sovereign citizens movement. I can tell you the government cares little about your – well, I guess there's the old saying, wolves care nothing about the opinion of sheep.
Hmm.
Just consider that. They really don't care what your opinion is.
You know, it's interesting you bring up the civil rights movement from the 1960s. I mean, if you think about it, there were, within that movement, there were plenty of people who did not recognize the so-called authority of the police because the police were enforcing really bad laws. And so when the police enforce bad laws on peaceful people, whether it be the war on drugs or the Jim Crow laws or whatever it is we're talking about, when the police enforce bad laws, they lose their perceived legitimacy. Because as the police become more violent towards peaceful people, as they are more likely to arrest you or your friends or your family members for piddly nonsense, then their legitimacy will wear away to the point where people will finally recognize them for the criminal gang that they represent. And I don't want to make it sound like I don't like the police. I find many of them to be likable human beings. I just think that they're doing the wrong thing. And the more they do wrong, the more they hurt peaceful people, the more simple it becomes to bring people on board with the idea that, hey, these guys don't have authority. They, I mean, how could they possibly have authority over you? If we are born equal, and I think most people accept that idea that you know, all men and women are created equal, that if we are born equal, then I cannot give you authority over me. I can't just give you authority that I don't have to give. I'm not over anyone else, so how can I give someone else that authority to rule over another person? Maybe I could give someone authority to make my decisions for me, but even then, I'm still giving them that ability. I'm still consenting to do that. Like if I, for instance, wanted to hire a dominatrix or something like that, I mean, I could certainly do that.
And I would like to, certainly could like to buy the pictures.
Would you? You're into that, huh?
I'd just to be amused. Huh. I'd post them on the internet.
How much are they worth?
Whatever. I don't know. It'd be an amusement factor, and I'm sure that it would get a lot of hits on the Facebook page.
Well, anyway, so, you know, in that case, I could certainly hire someone to tell me what to do, but I'm consenting in that case. There's a transaction going on there. There's an agreement. And of course, the government doesn't have that consent, even though in all their founding documents, they mention the idea of consent. You just try to withdraw your consent and see how that goes.
Yeah, I don't have to pay a woman to tell me what to do. I have a wife.
Toll-free number tonight, 855-450-FREE. You can also join us via Skype at Skype username LRN.FM. So my point being that, you know, back in the 60s, back in the, you know, the civil rights movement, there was all kinds of destruction of the authority of the police back then. And so, you know, it probably wouldn't be impossible to call some of those people sovereign citizens at that time. I'm sure the police considered them to be very dangerous, the people who were out protesting, because not all of them were just, you know, peaceful protesters. You have to remember, you had, you know, kind of different factions, right? You had the Martin Luther King peace-style faction, and then there was the more Malcolm X-style let's-use-violence faction.
Well, I think that the to some extent the sovereign citizen lashback or whatever is a problem created by the culture of the, I don't know what to call it, with the police in this country. Call it militarization, call it fanaticism of the police in this country. But when you look at countries like Great Britain and Canada and Germany and Australia, and you see these places and the amount of people they kill in a year, and look at it per capita,
it's much smaller.
It's much smaller, and
sometimes zero.
It's incredible. When you, I think it was Germany was last year, it was one, mm-hmm. And over the course of 2 years, it was eight. It's fair to look at a larger stretch of time.
Isn't Iceland like one? Ever?
One ever, yeah.
Iceland. Over all time.
Yeah, but they're a relatively new country, too. Yeah. So.
So, anyway.
And the police, by the way, came to the funeral, right? Yeah. Like, can you imagine for a second the police coming to the funeral of somebody they shot in this country? I don't imagine that for a second. 1,100 people in 2014. I'm not saying that there aren't plenty of people that deserve to get shot by the police in 2014. What I'm saying is that every shooting that isn't super justified just devalues the force generally.
Right, and I think that drives people towards these conspiracy theories. It drives people who are looking for an answer. That's what a lot of these folks who are considered sovereign citizens are doing. They're frustrated by what they see. They don't feel like there's anything that's going to change it. Doesn't matter if they, you know, they've figured out some of the things they're right about. I mean, they are right about some stuff. And some of the things they might be right about is that, well, the political system isn't going to change this. The political parties, the Republicans and the Democrats, haven't done anything to rein in the police state. They've been expanding it. So the frustration leads people to desperation, and sometimes desperation leads to violence. I'm not excusing it, just explaining it. 855-450-FREE is the toll-free number here tonight. Mark, coming up, you've got the story about the police who are now having a hard time hiring. Again, this has to do with their legitimacy being destroyed by their own actions. 855-450-FREE. It's Free Talk Live.
You hear that, kid? That's the hum of a well-run facility. You know what I hate hearing? Silence. Silence on a production line means downtime. Downtime means wasted time. Wasted time means wasted money. Silence isn't golden, kid. It's deadly. That's why I love Grainger. With a wide variety of the latest products, Grainger gets us what we need when we need it to help keep this place up and running and humming away. Get it? Got it? Good. Call, click Grainger.com, or stop by. Grainger, for the ones who get it done.
Do you drink coffee? Was the last cup of coffee you had really good? Free Talk Live has teamed up with BuzzBox to bring you the best of the best coffee. Shade grown, organic, top 1% grade Arabica. But what's different is for every 10 people that get their coffee through coffee.freetalklive.com, we can give another microloan through Kiva. Get a free pound to try it out. A free pound of the best coffee. Help others one cup at a time. coffee.freetalklive.com.
Shiny badges on your jacket. Shiny badges.
This is Davi Barker from ShinyBadges.com, and I just want to personally apologize for airing a jingle week after week, month after month, that turned out to be such an infectious brain worm. So to make it up to you, I'm offering a free gift. The next time you make a purchase at ShinyBadges.com, write WORMS in the transaction comments, and I'll send you something weird.
DVD, books, music, instruments, periodicals, computers, software, electronics, photo, cell phone, office products, home and garden, bed and bath, furniture, kitchen, pet supplies, automotive, hardware, apparel, shoes, jewelry, grocery, healthcare, sports and outdoors, toys, games, used and more. It's a department store at your fingertips. Shop.freetalklive.com. Get all your shopping done, get a great deal, and a portion of your purchase goes to benefit Free Talk Live when you enter Amazon via shop.freetalklive.com.
You're listening to the live edition of Free Talk Live. Hour number three is next after the news here on the Liberty Radio Network at LRN.FM.
This is the Liberty Beat, your daily source for Liberty news and activist updates. Online at thelibertybeat.com. I'm Brian Hagan with your Liberty Beat for Friday, February 20th, 2015. Gold opened today at $1,207, down $2. Silver opened at $16.32, down 16 cents. And Bitcoin is trading around $247. Today's metal price is brought to you by Midas Resources Incorporated, helping clients convert their paper 401ks and IRAs to solid gold and silver. Get their 10 Reasons book free by calling 800-686-2237. That's 800-686-2237. How much food is in your pantry right now? Could you feed your family for 2 weeks, 1 week? How about even 3 days without any help? Well, keeping an emergency food storage kit is the most effective way to begin to ensure your family's well-being during an emergency. eFoods Direct is food security for whatever the future holds. Go to eFoodsDirect.com/LibertyBeat or call 800-620-5520 to learn more about food security in a time of crisis. In the news, the president of Sudan has made headlines after claiming that Islamic extremist groups ISIS and Boko Haram are a creation of the Central Intelligence Agency and Israel's Mossad. President Omar al-Bashir told Euronews both stand behind the organizations as, quote, there is no Muslim who would carry out such acts, end quote. Al-Bashir also warned against taking violent actions against the groups, stating it would only elicit more violence. The statements echo similar claims made by the leader of Lebanon's Hezbollah group and the mayor of the Turkish city Ankara, who also claimed the Mossad was involved in the Charlie Hebdo attacks in Paris. The U.S. Department of Justice will likely sue the Ferguson, Missouri Police Department if recommendations are not implemented. The news comes as Attorney General Eric Holder is expected to announce the conclusions of a DOJ investigation into the shooting of Michael Brown and the Ferguson Police Department. CNN reports the DOJ would be forced to sue the department if they do not agree to review and revise tactics. Ferguson Police Chief Thomas Jackson stated he has heard nothing new from the Justice Department. DARPA is developing a new search engine specifically focused on the so-called dark or deep web. Known as Memex, the project is being worked on by 17 different contractor teams with the goal of gathering content largely missed by the major search engines, as well as cataloging thousands of sites on the deep web. The Liberty Beat is sponsored by the Free State Project. Want to find liberty in your lifetime? Then join thousands of others who are making the move to New Hampshire, the freest state in the Union. To learn more or to pledge to move today, visit freestateproject.org. Support also comes from Central Texas Gunworks, your online source for firearms, firearm accessories, and ammunition. They take major credit cards and now accept Bitcoin. Visit them online at shop.centraltexasgunworks.com. This is the Liberty Beat for Friday, February 20th, 2015. Check out the website at thelibertybeat.com. New documents from whistleblower Edward Snowden reveal the National Security Agency and the British hacked into a SIM card manufacturer in the Netherlands and now has access to encryption keys that allow monitoring of voice calls and metadata. The Intercept released the new documents, which show the agencies gained access to encryption keys that are built into the SIM cards and now monitor mobile communications without approval or knowledge of the company or foreign governments. The target of the hack was Gemalto, a SIM card manufacturer that produces SIM cards for 450 wireless companies, including AT&T, Sprint, T-Mobile, and Verizon. The Electronic Frontier Foundation stated they believe the NSA and GCHQ violated international law. Following a recent court decision, thousands of people have signed up for a collaborative challenge to spying campaigns by the British government communications headquarters. Human rights group Privacy International has launched an initiative that allows anyone in the world to join their efforts to file a lawsuit against the Investigatory Powers Tribunal. The tribunal recently ruled the GCHQ had violated the law by sharing data with the National Security Agency. The lawsuit would seek specific details on what individuals have been targeted by the GCHQ. The Liberty Beat is brought to you by CoinArch, offering innovative online trading solutions for Bitcoin. Visit CoinArch.com and sign up using coupon code MAX and get free brokerage for the first 7 days. It only takes $10 to start an account. That's CoinArch.com. Support also comes from the Conscious Resistance Network. Videos, news reports, and articles from a spiritual anarchist perspective. Experience the Conscious Resistance at theconsciousresistance.com. This is the Liberty Beat for Friday, February 20th, 2015. I'm Brian Hagan, reporting, reminding you, spread liberty with a smile.
Amid the catastrophic economic crisis spurred by Tuesday's release of This Christmas, the new holiday-themed album by John Travolta and Olivia Newton-John, economic experts told reporters today the Christmas CD has quickly plunged the nation into a double-dip recession.
When investors learned that one-time screen couple John Travolta and Olivia Newton-John had reunited after 35 years for an album of timeless Christmas classics, investors had no choice but to pull money from markets immediately. We were already on shaky ground with the collapse of the U.S. subprime mortgage market and the reversal financial crisis in Europe, but consumer confidence plummeted after Americans saw the new album with a picture of Travolta and Olivia Newton-John holding cups of hot cocoa. We believe that when other countries find out the album features a Christmas song that pays tribute to summer nights, we could be looking at a global contagion. This is the blackest day on Wall Street in 2 decades.
This is the Onion News Network.
We are back with more Free Talk Live on this live Sunday edition of the program. You, of course, are invited to join us here on the air and talk about anything you want to discuss at 855-450-FREE. That's the toll-free number, 855-450-3733. We also have Skype, and you can Skype into the show at username lrn.fm. Coming up, Mark, you've got the story about the police. They're having a tough time hiring, apparently, and they're blaming social media?
That's the claim.
All right, we'll get into that story when we get the chance. But to the phones first, where Bruce is on the line listening in the Asheville area of North Carolina to WWNC. Hey, Bruce.
How you doing, guys?
Welcome, sir. Go ahead.
Yeah, I don't think the question is not that there are such low killings by police in other countries, but the question is why there are such lows, you know?
Okay.
And what do you think?
And I think that it's just, in a way, to give it a quick get-to-the-end answer is greed. We give away too much in this country. You know, not that we shouldn't, but there's a lot of situations where it seems like unfair things happen. One parent decides that her child is affected by a manger on stage, and the other 300 have to suffer. You know, things like that. And then also in the welfare system. I mean, these people are getting more than my wife and I together.
European countries have a much more robust welfare state than the United States has. And, you know, there's no lack of PC behavior in Europe.
How do you get from that to people being killed by the police? Maybe I'm missing the connection.
More crime.
Meaning the people on welfare are more likely to commit crime, is what you're saying?
Well, I don't know. It just seems like America's more in a turmoil than over in Europe. You know, they still have houses that have been lived in for 700 years. I mean,
we've got 300-year-old houses.
They listen to the slower things in life more than America. America wants get up and go.
I have another theory for you, and I want you to try this on and see what you think. It's the drug war. In European countries, they do not nearly as rigorously enforce drug prohibition as they do in the United States. And in some European countries, Portugal, for instance, they've decriminalized all drugs, not just marijuana, but I'm talking about heroin and cocaine and those sorts of things. And that they've seen in that time a decrease in crime, all crimes, as a result.
That's correct.
Well, but okay, so you can jump to whatever conclusion you want. I say it's as a result of the decriminalization, but certainly they've had a decrease in drug-related crimes.
What is the crime rate in Copenhagen?
I have no idea. Do you?
No, I don't. But, I mean, those are places that give away all those drugs. I don't either.
Well, they give away needles, but they don't give away the drugs.
Away the needles.
Heroin's illegal in Amsterdam, but, you know,
they still have injection rooms or whatever, right?
Yeah, like they have places.
Run by churches.
Yep. Places where you can go, and the intention is that you get, you know, they're trying to knock down rates of HIV and hepatitis C and the things like that. You know, that's that.
There's also a culture, Mark. I agree with you on, like, the war on drugs is kind of the basis for the militarization of the police in the United States.
I'd say you'd cut down 90% over time prison population as a result.
Well, I think that's true, but also there's become a culture that has been created within the police because of this. So because of the militarization of the police, you know, it's one of those things where you keep going down that road, you keep getting more and more and more of it, and so you create a militarized police force, and you're likely to attract the kind of recruit who wants to be a part of a militarized police force rather than the kind of recruit who's coming in because, you know, they want to help people, they want to stop the bad guys. Instead, you get somebody who wants to come in and use his badge to be able to get away with murder or hurting people, you know, pummeling people and that kind of thing. We had a police trainer guy who was listening to our show for a while. He called the show and we met him in real life, so I believe his story.
He looked like a police trainer.
Yeah, he trained police, and he said he quit doing the police training field because he was so disappointed with the quality of the recruits these days, that they had markedly been getting worse over time. And he said that maybe 1 out of 10 recruits was what he considered to be an actual quality recruit, and the other 9 out of 10 were people who were either wanting to be badge heavies and throw their weight around and hurt people, or they were just obviously in it for, you know, corrupt kind of purposes as well, like wanting to steal drugs and make money and that kind of thing. So I think there's a real sort of ingrained culture of police power now, and that's poisoning the well even worse. Any other thoughts, Bruce?
I used to live in Tampa about 10 years ago in Florida, and I had a situation in my house, and when the police came, I was talking to the policeman. He said, and I asked that same question about, you know, policemen, and he said 33% of them just want a paycheck, a job. 33% of them are on retirement, getting close to it, and they don't want to get in any trouble. And the other 33% are probably like rookies, and they really don't know what they're doing. That's what the cop told me.
It's interesting. Bruce, thanks for your call tonight. I appreciate hearing from you. The toll-free number is 855-450-FREE. It's interesting when you get a police officer sort of on his own when he's not really being watched by anyone and get him to actually answer some questions about what it's like being a police officer and get the real truth, or at least what the truth might be more likely to be. His frank opinion. Yeah, as opposed to the public persona of the police department. I knew a guy who was a detective in New York City police, and he told me that everyone was corrupt. Everyone.
I've met so many police officers that I believe to be just really good people. You know, like you just feel like that you could trust them to do this job or that job. But I think it really sort of takes more than that. The fact is that power corrupts the very best people, and power also corrupts very corruptible people. So you have this sort of weird situation going where the police department will attract sort of people you really don't want to be police officers. And now that we're hiring more and more and more because the drug war and militarization ramps up, and it also attracts these, I think, people that genuinely sort of look at themselves as heroes, that they would do what it takes to get the job done, throw themselves in front of a bullet for you, you know, those kind of folks. I really believe they're there, but I think that in many ways they're stifled, that they can't sort of report on the corruption that they're dealing with because the corruption runs up the ranks and mm-hmm. they would never get anywhere. You know, they want to, you know, try to change things from the inside. And we all know how difficult that can be. Changing things from the outside isn't exactly easy either. Changing things is not easy. So, you know, I feel for people in that position. It's got to be a terrible position.
Share your thoughts with us here toll-free at 855-450-FREE. Mark, tell us a story about the police having a difficult time recruiting, because they're digging their own grave on this one. This is all they're doing. They're going to blame it on social media? No, it's because social media is just passing around what's really happening with the police.
Okay, so this is from filmingcops.com, and the way it's written, there's an update sort of in the beginning, so it has a little bit of you know, the continuity of the story isn't exactly right.
Okay.
But I think what it says is important, so I'm going to read it the way it's written. Interest in being a cop continues to plummet. New figures have been released by WBAY showing that Seattle isn't the only place where law enforcement jobs are undesired. The Green Bay, Wisconsin interest in getting hired as a law enforcement officer has dropped dramatically at nearly 50%. Our numbers are dropping, says Captain Sanborn with the Brown County Sheriff's Department. We're struggling to get people to apply, says Lieutenant Brester with the Green Bay Police Department.
Maybe they should just go on the streets and start kidnapping recruits.
You mean like they do jurors?
Yeah.
I don't know. It would be interesting to see what would happen if you would just take regular citizens and sort of give them a quick training course and tell them to be cops. I would think that would be a bad thing to do.
Yeah,
but
no, it doesn't sound like a good idea. That was a joke.
Yeah, it's interesting.
Yeah.
When they asked why they think their numbers were sinking, Sanborn replied,
"I don't know."
I would say negative feedback, negative publicity. Law enforcement publicly, even in the last 2 years, law enforcement publicity, even in the last 2 or 3 years. Ferguson, obviously, being one of them. In 2013, only 88 applicants for police work performed the written examination. In 2014, the number was even less. Only 47 took the test.
Hold on. Where was that? Were those numbers?
He's talking about the Brown County, so it's somewhere near Green Bay.
Stand by. We'll come back with more of the story here. What was the source on this again?
This is filmingcops.com.
All right. There's more on the way here at 855-450-FREE. You can share your thoughts. Why are the police having a tough time recruiting people to be cops? You can share your thoughts on Free Talk Live.
And now from the Cato Institute, the Cato Constitution Minute. To our founders, regular elections were crucial since they would help ensure that government was responsive and responsible to the people. Yet our founders knew that democracy alone wasn't enough to protect liberty. At times, a majority can be as dangerous as a king or dictator, and so our Constitution limits the power of the majority. As Supreme Court Justice Robert Jackson wrote in 1943, one's right to life, liberty, and property and other fundamental rights may not be submitted to vote. They depend on the outcome of no elections. This principle is even more important today, with many of our laws not written by elected officials, but instead drafted or deeply influenced by outsiders who cannot be removed from office by voters. And so the Constitution limits government power because elections, while necessary for democracy, are not sufficient to protect freedom. To learn more, visit the Cato Institute online at cato.org.
This is Mark of Free Talk Live. We've been witnessing a meltdown of the economic engine that powers our country. With a printing press tethered to Washington bureaucrats and New York central bankers, how can we trust paper money? For years, I've been buying gold and silver from Midas Resources, and you should too. Call 877-357-9938 for a free book titled 10 Reasons to Own Gold, or go to gold.freetalklive.com. Again, 877-357-9938, 877-357-9938.
Farmers keep livestock lean and healthy with a mineral-rich diet. Then, before market, they cut off minerals, leaving them to crave high-calorie grains. If weight control is this easy, why prescribe surgery for humans? Introducing Youngevity. You could avoid 900 diseases by getting 90 essential nutrients from Youngevity. Check out 90 for Life at tobeyoungagain.com or call 855-79-YOUNG. That's 855-79-YOUNG or tobeyoungagain.com. Youngevity. It's all about saving money, getting healthy, and creating wealth.
This alert just came in. This special announcement is for business owners and leaders of organizations who've been waiting for the right time to build. General Steel has made it impossible to wait any longer with rock-bottom prices that could save you thousands. That's right. General Steel, America's leader in pre-engineered structures, is offering buildings at prices you will never see again. Don't miss these prices. A 50 by 100 for under $30,000. You heard right. That's 5,000 square feet under $30,000. Manufacturers, if you need a larger building, try a 100 by 100 commercial building for $129,000. You can't afford to rent with these prices. Imagine a 70 by 100 foot church building for under $69,000. With the economy improving and interest rates still at historic lows, you can't afford to wait.
Call 800-917-8251. 800-917-8251. 800-917-8251.
The three most important things you can do for Free Talk Live are, one, share one episode a week on Facebook or in some other social networking site. Two, buy the things you buy online through shop.freetalklive.com. Three, give $5 a month to the AMP program. It's my firm belief that Free Talk Live's AMP program is the best use of your charitable dollar among liberty-oriented organizations. Support all the organizations you love. But make sure you give $5 a month to AMP at amp.freetalklive.com. I love My Magic Mud. I drink a lot of coffee. I had stains on my teeth. Then I found My Magic Mud, and I was told it would remove stains. So I paid attention when I brushed the first time. My Magic Mud is black tooth powder, and the difference it made in my teeth in one application was noticeable. With four, my teeth were as white as you normal folks out there. Please go to MyMagicMud.com and buy a jar. There's 150 applications for $25. You can use Bitcoin. MyMagicMud.com.
What's up next? Visit the Liberty Radio Network program guide to find out at shows.lrn.fm. That's shows.lrn.fm.
Free Talk Live. Dial on in toll free. Bring up anything you'd like. The number here is 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733. And, of course, you can join us online at freetalklive.com.
So we're going to the Texas Bitcoin Conference in Austin at the end of March, it's the 28th and 29th of March. It's in downtown Austin at the Moody Theater. They're going to have all kinds of great speakers there. We're obviously going to be there. Free Talk Live is going to be there. That's going to be a lot of fun to meet our Southern listeners who are coming to the Texas Bitcoin Conference. Please come out and see us. But they're also going to have David Johnston, who's from BitAngels, who's running one of the most exciting Bitcoin operations in the world. It's the annual Texas Bitcoin Conference $1 million Bitcoin 2.0 hackathon. So this is in conjunction with the Bitcoin Conference. They run this hackathon, and they give away $1 million to at least one or, you know, maybe multiple organizations or ideas. I don't really know what to call somebody who puts something together. It's kind of like a Shark Tank situation, and a hackathon's like that. And I think it's going to be really great stuff. Also, Jason King, Robert Murphy, Vitalik Buterin, Charlie Shrim, IBM's architect of their blockchain technology, Simbalam Nair, George Gilder, the guy who basically created Reaganomics. It's going to be an interesting conference. Please come out. TexasBitcoinConference.com to get your tickets. Tickets are
very low cost, and you can save $20, $25 by using coupon code FTL. It's a $150 ticket, $25 off with our coupon code, and then $25 of your remaining $125 is going to be donated to Sean's Outpost. That's the charity we picked. So it's TexasBitcoinConference.com. Come out and be a part of the future. TexasBitcoinConference.com, coupon code FTL.
Yeah, look forward to seeing you there. So, Mark, you're telling us it's getting harder to find police or people who are willing to become police. We'll continue with your story about that here in a moment. But first, Quillen is on the line in Asheville, listening to WWNC. Hello, Quillen.
Hello. How are you, gentlemen?
Welcome, sir. Go ahead.
I don't think that the fact that it's becoming harder to get police and military folks, the military recruiters are getting all they need. I think it's a part of how we're raised. What did you want to be when you were a child?
I remember wanting to be a an archaeologist.
Archaeologist. Well, you're one of the few. I think most people wanted to be a fireman.
Yeah, that was like when I was like three. Yeah, sure.
Yes, a police officer, a fireman, because we thought those callings were noble.
Yep. I'd still say there's a lot of nobility in the firefighting realm.
Well, and I agree with you. There are. There's a lot of nobility in the public offerings where you have police officers and firefighters and teachers.
Yeah, yeah.
That give up their lives for not a lot.
They're not giving up their lives. Teachers and police, they're getting paid very, very well. I'd like to point out, especially in
comparison. But they don't have a real upward. What they're giving up is that chance of sort of being, you know, the upward mobility. They're giving up the opportunity to start their own business and that kind of things. So they do get pensions.
Yeah, maybe I misspoke. Yes, they're not giving up their lives. They're giving up the ability to become extremely wealthy at what they do.
There are a lot of people who, don't have much upward mobility. They can go and get a job at McDonald's, and, you know, odds are good they're never going to become the manager there. That doesn't mean that they're...
But is that a calling? Is that a calling, like a police officer? Or
I don't know. I mean, some people really like to serve others' food.
Let the man make his point. I'd like to hear the remainder of the point.
I'm fine to hear the remainder of it, but I'm sick and tired of people associating the government bureaucrats with this sort of honorable thing, that somehow it's more honorable to go and work for the government than it is to create a product or a service that is helping people in the marketplace. I'm not saying that teachers aren't needed out there, but there's a saying about teachers, those who can do and those who can't teach. So I'm sick and tired of having these government bureaucrats given the benefit of the doubt that they're just so wonderful and magnanimous, and really many of them are just looking for a paycheck. They're looking for that sweet government paycheck and the government benefits and the government pensions person doesn't get.
He's not making the claim that that's not
the
case.
You know, the funny thing is you can be sick and tired of it all you want, but the fact of the matter is, it is not a job you're going to go to earn a lot of money. You're not going to do this to become wealthy. You're going to do this because you desire to do it. You're going to put yourself in harm's way.
That's not true, though. That's not true. I mean, I gave you the example.
Yes,
I gave you an example a moment ago before you were on the line about a police recruiter, who quit. A trainer, actually. He trains recruits, or he did. He quit because he was sick and tired of the poor quality people who were coming in to take those jobs. They were people who wanted to use power over others. They weren't people who wanted to help people.
And I don't disagree with you. I don't disagree with you on that. But what I'm saying is we have downgraded those jobs insofar as society looks at them to a point to where they're no longer upheld to a standard above everything else.
That's because it's too easy to get to those jobs now. I mean, there's just so many police officers.
Maybe that's true. So we're not disagreeing with each other. What I'm saying is, when I was a child, and I'm 47 years old, I aspired to be a police officer, a fireman, or a doctor, one of those. And that's why I asked you, what did you want to be when you grew up? Because those jobs, at one point, were the pinnacle of society. And
that's ridiculous.
Our society has downgraded. No, it's not ridiculous.
No, it's ridiculous to call the police the pinnacle of society. I mean, the police forever have been the enforcers of the government politicians, all the way from back in the days of slavery. Was that the pinnacle of society when they were taking escaped slaves and forcing them to return to the plantation?
Those weren't the police.
Yes,
those
they were.
The slave owners? No, they weren't. How many police, insofar as a percentage of society, were those people at that time?
Well, I can tell you that many police departments were comprised of the.
You can't give me that answer because you're just trying to be a rebel rouser.
Well, no, I can go ahead and read you the story from.
Wait a second. The people who brought the slaves back to the plantations were not police.
Now, no, but they became the police.
I am a first generation American.
So what?
My family came from Cuba. So what? We lost everything due to a police state. We have been given every opportunity to succeed in this country based on our own validity. I am getting a master's degree in information security as XP. And it's because I've worked my ass off. My family has become prolific in this country. Because we have been given the opportunity to succeed.
I think that the Cubans are a great example of people that have come to this country and really, availed themselves. And I think it's many of the longer-term Americans, generations past, that have gotten sort of lackadaisical. They won't do the jobs that need to be done. But I have some of the problems. Historically, I can tell you that the police departments rose up out of slave trade. I've got an article right here.
I'll bring Quillen back here. If you want to stick with us, you're welcome to continue the conversation. It's up to you. 855-450-FREE is the toll-free number. That's 855-450-3733. The pinnacle of society? Yeah. I would chalk that one up to entrepreneurs, not the cops. They just follow orders. It's Free Talk Live.
This is Dan Pilla. Do you owe the IRS money you can't pay? Are tax debts crippling you? I've defended people from the IRS for over 30 years. I've helped thousands, and I can help you too. I wrote the book on IRS settlement, and I'm telling you, there's no such thing as a hopeless case. Call 800-34-NO-TAX to finally get free of IRS debt. With the IRS's new programs, there's never been a better time to solve your problem. Call 800-34-NO-TAX. That's 800-34-NO-TAX or my website, danpilla.com.
It's no secret that government and big business buy in bulk and get huge discounts not available to the little guy. Until now. Introducing a breakthrough crowd buying website where people can join together, buy in bulk, and get massive discounts on millions of popular products. It's TogetherSave.com. TogetherSave.com. You can save 20, 30, or even 50% off tablets, smartphones, cars, appliances, textbooks, sports equipment, video games, and much more. All with free delivery. Check it out. TogetherSave.com. Visit now and start group buying today at TogetherSave.com.
Free Press Publications is an independent, alternative media and publishing company founded in June 2009 with the mission of ensuring a free press for the freedom movement and is committed to spreading the message of peace, freedom, love, and liberty. FPP also gives new authors an avenue for publishing freedom-oriented material. FPP brings you daily news and commentary on the website fpp.cc, as well as a daily 5-minute newscast, FPP Radio News, and weekly news, views, and commentary in the FPP Freedom Minute and Peace, Love, Liberty Radio at fppradio.com, and the monthly newspaper FPP News at news.fpp.cc. Find FPP online at fpp.cc. That's fpp.cc, as in Creative Commons.
Majid lives in Nordevin, Armenia, with his wife, kids, and grandkids, all in the same house. They have cows, but to compete against the big ranchers, Majid needed to get a loan for more cattle. Free Talk Live helped him get a loan for the cows. He bought them, and now he's very happy with the expansion of his farm. You can help us help more people by getting your coffee through coffee.freetalklive.com. Make a difference, one cup at a time. Get a free pound to try out the subscription. Cancel at any time. coffee.freetalklive.com.
You can listen to Free Talk Live on the radio, podcast, satellite, webcam, and our live streams. But did you know you can listen to Free Talk Live from any phone, anywhere? Add this number to your phone, 213-493-0308. It's a long-distance call, so make sure you're familiar with your phone's calling plan. The Listen Lines are airing the latest episode of Free Talk Live 24 hours a day, including our live shows. Call 213-493-0308. That's 213-493-0308. On Free Talk Live, we're bringing people to the ideas of liberty every day. From wrestling superstars like Glenn Jacobs.
You guys really are having an impact, I believe. Like I said, a lot of where I am now is due to listening to Free Talk Live. You changed my mind on some very important issues years ago.
To random people tuning in on the radio.
I was kind of stuck in the left-right paradigm. I heard your show by chance on a Saturday night. From there, I went on, joined the Free State Project and become an amplifier. So, I mean, that's really the reason why I amp is because I know that if it wasn't for you guys being on as many stations as you are, I never would have found the ideas of liberty.
Your amp will directly change more lives by getting Free Talk Live in front of people looking for talk radio online and on the air. You can help by joining the AMP program for just $5 a month at amp.freetalklive.com and getting perks. That's amp.freetalklive.com.
If you enjoy LRN.FM, please contribute to your favorite shows via their websites and become an amplifier at amp.lrn.fm. That's amp.lrn.fm.
Free Talk Live. Dial toll-free here on this live Sunday edition. We'll take your calls about anything that's on your mind at 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733. We've got Skype as well. Skype username here is lrn.fm. And want to invite you to the upcoming Liberty Forum, the 2015 edition of this amazing event that has not quite hit its first decade, but it's getting there. I think the first one was in 2007, and we were there for it. We were there at every single Liberty Forum ever since. We're going to be there again this year, broadcasting live. We'll look forward to seeing you. And there's really no reason not to attend, considering that we can get you free tickets. Now, there are certain qualifications you have to meet in order to get the free ticket. So here's what you have to do.
So we might not be able to get you free tickets.
Yeah. We can get you a free ticket if you are not yet a Free State Project signer. So if you have not yet signed the statement of intent for the Free State Project, maybe you're on the fence, you're uncertain about the Free State Project, you want to check it out, Liberty Forum's a great opportunity to do that. So you can't
or
yet,
just you want to come to Liberty Forum.
You can't yet be a Free State Project signer. You also cannot yet live in New Hampshire. So you have to be outside of New Hampshire and not yet be a signer. And finally, you have to agree to attend one session at the Liberty Forum, which is called the FSP Questions Session with Carla Mora. It's happening on Saturday afternoon at 12:30. And that's all. If you're willing to commit to attending that one session and you don't live in New Hampshire and you're not yet a Free State Project signer, I can get you a free ticket. I can get you more than one if, you know, you've got a group of people that meet those qualifications. So email me, ian@freetalklive.com, and I will get your name over to the organizer to lock in your free ticket to the Liberty Forum, which is coming up here in less than 2 weeks, March 5th through the 8th. People are going to be in Manchester, New Hampshire at the Radisson Hotel. It's the biggest convention space in New Hampshire. This is an awesome, awesome change for the Liberty Forum. It's been at a great hotel in the past in Nashua, but they're moving it to the big city now, and it's time for it to occupy the largest space available. It's a great event. You don't want to miss it. So go to nhlibertyforum.com to learn more about the event. And if you want to take me up on that free ticket offer, just email me at ian@freetalklive.com. We got Quillen back on the line with us here in Asheville. But Mark, what did you want to
say? Well, I just want to say that I think that this is much more a communication issue than anything else. You're being unnecessarily nitpicky with the things that Quillen says. And that Quillen is kind of doing the whole conservative shtick where hearkening back to a time when things were wonderful, you know, like the 50s when they were beating black people over the head and having dogs attack them. You know, so like this is like you guys agree on what you're saying largely.
I don't know if I agree with Quillen. What do you think I agree with Quillen about?
Go ahead, Quillen.
You said that it was the pinnacle of, I said it was the pinnacle. And maybe I misspoke because when I was growing up and I asked you when I first came on the line, what did you want to be when you grew up? And most of my friends and I, our answer was a policeman or a fireman or a doctor.
Yep.
And the idea of those careers was so much better than it is now. You ask somebody what they want to be now, and those answers are not the same.
I have no clue what the answers might be. I probably should ask my son's friends. He's seven, but he says he wants to be a scientist. So, I mean, that sounds pretty good to me.
My 8-year-old daughter now says she wants to be a baby doctor, and she has since she was very little. And so the doctor is still there. But I wonder how many kids now say doctor or fireman or policeman or fireman, because we have vilified those careers.
Who has vilified those careers?
The society has, because we look at stuff that happens from police. A policeman shoots somebody, and then we look at it and say, that's a horrible thing that's happened. Yes, it is a horrible thing. But then we don't look at how the situation occurred necessarily.
Oh, you sometimes can look at plenty of those situations. We've looked at countless situations where the police have murdered innocent people and destroyed the lives of innocent people without even, you know, without killing them necessarily, but simply by arresting them, destroying their house.
Well, you mentioned Ferguson.
I think that was mentioned in an article, but I would like to mention the baby who's had their face blown off by the flashbang grenade.
And I don't disagree with you. Disagree with you. No, do I want to get shot by a cop who has an overinflated ego? No.
I don't think that's an overinflated ego on that police officer. In the case of the baby, I think those police officers were following protocol. They threw a flashbang grenade in before they went in on a drug bust.
Well, and then... You know, that's a horrible situation.
Yeah.
Well,
that's a horrible situation. But I'm a 90% disabled military veteran. Have I thrown a flashbang grenade before I entered into a room where I knew there were people who were trying to kill me? Yes. Did I think about the situation of a child possibly being in that room when I was getting shot at, or I knew there was a dangerous situation happening in that room before?
Yeah, well, the only dangerous situation in the room were the police in this particular case, and that's usually the only danger in any of these 40,000 or 50,000 raids that go on a yearly basis. It's the police that are creating the danger, because if they want to go and bust somebody for drugs, all they have to do is wait for the guy to leave the house and go to the grocery store or the convenience store or whatever and arrest him then. They want to be in a dangerous situation. They like the adrenaline rush. They want to go in there with guns a-blazing and bombs firing and all of that. And it's sick. And they deserve all of the disdain that people have sent towards them, because they've earned it.
And you know what? And to a certain degree, you're right. Because what is the biggest ad for video games on TV right now?
I don't know. I watch
TV. Have you seen it? Okay.
Just tell us.
Well, right now, you look at these ads that are on TV, and you see these young guys or girls, and they're on TV, and they're given a word, and the word is become or succeed or something of that nature, which it gives them a goal, and then they show them playing a video game, and it gives them a false sense of security. It gives them a false sense of
success.
Yes. And I agree with you.
Because with video games, you really can you achieve things in video games, and it feels like an achievement, and it's nothing real.
It's nothing real.
It's true.
A lot of people that get these senses of security or senses of achievement from, say, becoming a police officer or becoming a soldier, they think that there is a point in which they're going to become a hero or heroic in their actions, when in reality, it is just most of the time, a daily grind. My job as a military, after spending many years in the Army and becoming a 90% disabled veteran, I spent 90% of my time or more bored.
Yeah, we knew a guy, Puke, who's actually an occasional fill-in co-host on Free Talk Live. He talks about how when he was in Iraq, they had him pushing dirt around with a broom. he was sweeping an airfield.
I didn't push a lot of dirt around, but I burnt some some 50-gallon barrels cut in half with poop in them with diesel oil, and that was not very glorious or...
Yeah. Doesn't sound very healthy either.
Quillen, I want to thank you for the call tonight, man. I appreciate the conversation,
and
I appreciate the call and the thoughts. The toll-free number is 855-450-FREE.
I did cite this, and I want to just point out the title here. From Eastern Kentucky University Police Studies Online, A Brief History of Slavery and the Origins of American Policing. The birth and development of the American police can be traced in a multitude of historical, legal, and political economic conditions. The institution of slavery and the control of minorities, however, are two of the more formidable historic features of American society shaping early policing. And this article goes on to, show the relationship of sort of historically American policing rising out of slave chasers.
Wow. All right.
And that is what it is. It means what it means, right? Like, the cotton industry in America rose out of slavery. That doesn't mean wearing a cotton shirt is terrible. It's just true.
And the toll-free number tonight, if you would like to share your thoughts with us, is 855-450-FREE. We have one segment remaining. Plenty of time for you if you dial in right now. 855-450-3733. This is Free Talk Live.
Times are different than they were when GEICO started saving people money over 75 years ago. Everybody takes photos of their food nowadays. You can bet none of us kids would snap pictures of Mom's tuna casserole surprise. To this day, we don't know what the surprise was, nor do we want to. We didn't always have tasty food, but we always had great car insurance with GEICO.
GEICO, saving people money on car insurance for over 75 years.
Nothing compares to a good cup of coffee. But if you're getting your coffee from the store, you're likely not getting a good cup of coffee. Free Talk Live's teamed up with BuzzBox to bring you a free pound of the best coffee, shade-grown, organic, top 1% grade Arabica. But what's different is that for every 10 people that get coffee through our link, coffee.freetalklive.com, we can give another microloan through Kiva. When the loan's paid, we lend the money again. Help others, one cup at a time, coffee.freetalklive.com.
This alert just came in. This special announcement is for business owners and leaders of organizations who've been waiting for the right time to build. General Steel has made it impossible to wait any longer with rock-bottom prices that could save you thousands. That's right, General Steel, America's leader in pre-engineered structures, is offering buildings at prices you will never see again. Don't miss these prices. A 50 by 100 for $35,000. You heard right, that's 5,000 square feet for $35,000. Manufacturers, if you need a larger building, try a 100 by 100 commercial building for $129,000. You can't afford to rent with these prices. Imagine a 70 by 100 foot church building for under $69,000. With the economy improving and interest rates still at historic lows, you can't afford to wait. So call 866-91-STEEL. Lock in your price now. Call 866-91-STEEL. That's 866-917-8335.
Are you looking for an excuse to come check out New Hampshire this fall? You're invited to Keenvention. Keenvention is your chance to meet dozens of key liberty activists from across the Shire. You can explore the beautiful little city of Keene, discuss various forms of activism with seasoned veterans, do some Robin Hooding, and learn about making the move. Keenvention received rave reviews last year. If you missed it, visit keenvention.info for full video coverage of every speaker and panel. This year's keynote speeches and panels will be announced via the Keenvention blog and Facebook, so stay tuned there for the latest. Join old and new friends and neighbors in Keene for Keenvention this October 30th through November 1st. Tickets are available now at a special super early bird price of just $40 via credit card or Bitcoin. That $40 price only lasts through early March, so don't delay. Reserve your tickets now at keenvention.info. Visit keenvention.info for more and look for our page and event on Facebook. That's keenvention.info. Did you know that you can listen to and watch Free Talk Live during our live show 7 days a week from 7 to 10 p.m. Eastern via our studio cam at cam.freetalklive.com? Not only that, but you can also chat with other listeners at the same time. Do I need to mention that both the studio cam and chat room are totally free? Outside of Free Talk Live's live hours, you won't see a cam feed, but we'll hear audio from the Liberty Radio Network. So listen, watch, and chat all free at cam.freetalklive.com. That's cam.freetalklive.com. Ross Ulbricht was convicted in early 2015 of running the infamous Silk Road Underground Market. The Silk Road was a gift to humanity and helped reduce the harms brought on by drug prohibition. For this good deed, Ross may be spending the rest of his life in prison. His family is planning to appeal his conviction, but they need your support. Please visit FreeRoss.org, where you can contribute via various methods, including Bitcoin. Ross needs your help now more than ever. Visit FreeRoss.org. That's FreeRoss.org.
You can watch the LRN Studio Cam and chat with other listeners anytime at cam.lrn.fm. That's cam.lrn.fm.
This is Free Talk Live. Moments remain, but enough time for you. If you dial now, 855-450-FREE, that's a toll-free number, 855-450-3733. With you tonight, you've got me, Ian.
And me, Mark.
Join us online at freetalklive.com. If you like what we're doing on Free Talk Live, then you can shop with us. Just go to shop.freetalklive.com. Enter Amazon through the links you'll find there. When you do that, Free Talk Live gets a cut of the sale. Very simple, easy way for us to get some of Amazon's profits. You just go to shop.freetalklive.com to get your shopping taken care of. As we go way over across the pond, where Tommy is with us in Glasgow on Skype. Hello, Tommy.
Hi, Ian. Hi, Mark.
Hey there. Go ahead, sir.
Hi, everybody across the pond there. It was an interesting chat there with the previous caller. Sorry, what was his name again?
Quinlan? Good question. Yeah, Quillen or something like that, I think.
Quillen. Yeah, interesting chat, yeah. The police, and interesting what Mark said there about the police and yourself, Ian. My take on it is, you know, when I was about 16, I was involved in a bit of soccer violence, soccer hooliganism.
You're a hooligan?
I was a hooligan until I mellowed out with some MDMA and acid and weed, yeah, and sorted me out and chilled me out and took me to a different perspective. You know, instead of wanting to bash people over the head, I was wanting to induce myself with nice things. But prior to that, I'd a wee escapade with the police. And both of the incidents were 1 week after each other. And one of the times I was caught walking across the road. And I was supposed to be the ringleader, but I was only the person leading the way up to the game that day, because the game was in the area where I stayed, so I knew the local vicinity. But somehow that made me a ringleader of the gang. And I only escaped going to jail because it was my first offence. Mm. But other people there were given 3 and 6 month sentence, and the crime was walking across the street.
Wow.
I was jailed for walking across the street. Yeah, jaywalking, and they said I was out to cause violence, and I was wearing a little blazer and nice bib and tucker. I was one of these casuals where you wear smart and trendy clothes. So here I was, a young 16-year-old boy, grabbed by the police, and then a week later, there was an outbreak of violence. It was one of the big games, Celtic against Rangers. There was an outbreak of violence about 10 yards in front of me. The police jumped out of about 3 different vans, and because I'd been jailed the week before, I decided to run away. And lo and behold, I'm not good at running, and who gets caught is me. And so, I try to explain that to your old mum, who is at wit's end, you know, what did I do? And I did nothing. But it was what happened, to cut a long story short, when I was in the court. The police were giving evidence, and there was about 7 or 8 of us. And as they were doing it, this was the second court case where I got a £25 fine, so it was just quite small. But the first one, I got about a £250 fine and just escaped jail. But it was what they did in the second one. And they pointed me out because I was the youngest, so that was me guilty. But the other ones in the other order, they messed everything up. And it turned out, and the judge threw it out because there was a couple of people who saw that, and they jumped up and says, hold on, he's given information. And what the copper did, who gave information, he had it in his pad, and he looked at it, and he was able to give evidence and say, oh, it was them. And then he sat there, and he tapped 3 fingers on his right, and the other copper looked at him on his right arm, and the people who were sitting there, the family saw what had happened. They've jumped up and said, hold on, he's helping. He says, no, shut up. The judge said, sit down, sit down. And what they were trying to do was point out that one of the police officers who gave evidence was helping the other one identify, and three of the people get jailed that day.
So just to clarify here, I'm a little lost. So what you're saying is you could tell that the officer was trying to cue one of the other people in the court with answers, like silently?
Yeah, it's like sounds like umpire, or like the catcher giving signals coaching to the pitcher.
So one of the police officers were in the dock, and he was asked to identify one of the jailed like 6 months before. But and I was the youngest. I was standing at the end, so they identified me. But the rest of them, they couldn't identify, and some of them managed to get off. But what one of the police did, one of the ones who gave evidence, first of all, helped the person who was trying to identify, and what he did, he put three fingers to his right arm, and then all of a sudden the police officer says, oh yeah, it's the third person from the right. And then he did it again and he says, oh, the fourth person from the left. And people at that time saw it and said, hold on, what's going on here? He's willingly giving him. But the whole thing about the police,
what ended up happening?
Well, I was the only person to get jailed because I get fined, and about three or four managed to get away from it because the police evidence was just all over the place. And then when everybody stood up and says, oh, hold on, but nothing happened to the police. If this was you or I doing something like in court, perverting the course of justice, we would have been given a straight sentence, 6 months, a year, throw away the keys. But the police pervert, and this was... I mean, they got away with it, but they never really... I mean, they were identified in court for doing it, but yeah. The judge was just saying throw it out, but that's what they get away
with
all
the time. Well, you can't prove it. I mean, you know, it's an interesting theory, but you can't prove for sure that
I think you're lucky
was,
with what you got away with, frankly. Yeah, I mean,
25
you know,
pounds
when it comes to these situations, it's tough. Thanks, Tommy,
for the call tonight. Appreciate hearing from you. Let's go to Justin Bieber. You're on Free Talk Live. Justin Bieber, you're on the air, going once. Going twice.
I think last night he made a fart noise.
That was, the fart guy from a couple nights ago. He didn't do that last night, though.
Okay.
James in Arizona, you're on Free Talk Live on Skype.
Speaking of you're digging your own grave, Ian and Mark, just keep doxing me online and getting your rocks off.
You speak a lot of my death, James.
I'm not talking about death, but
you did mention grave.
Our creator. Yep. It's called... hyperbole, vitriol, if you want to call it that.
Yeah.
But keep on doing it. I know once you said a long time ago, like last week, you try to show love and respect for your callers, even though you've been posting stupid memes about me on your page for almost a year now.
James, what I'm doing is I'm documenting
one of these days you're going to regret it.
I want to make sure. I'm going to
want to make sure that you hear.
See, that's the point, James.
Even so much as Google.
I'm telling you right now, the reason I am documenting the crap that you say to us over a Skype that you believe that you're doing in the dark of night, the reason I'm documenting is because I consider you a threat to me and my family, James. What do you say to that?
I have never touched a hair on anybody's head in my life.
But you talk about my death a great deal, sir.
Keep on saying that stupid implying that I would ever hurt you. I won't even touch a hair on your head. I'll use my own God-given brain to make you suffer, you
You're
loser.
Not suffering. I believe
you're
you, sir.
You're a loser.
I do.
You're a fraud.
Okay, fraud of what? Loser how?
Talk lies.
I feel like
you're
I'm doing okay.
That lies. You're a preacher that lies for a living, and you're going to stop breathing one of these days.
Yep, so
I don't
there he is.
My
death.
You
what,
sure
again?
As hell should. You're a loser.
Okay, I'm a loser. See, this is the kind of stuff you say. You don't back it up. I don't feel like a loser.
I'm not Googling your name and posting shit about you online.
Thanks for the call tonight. By the way, I don't know what he's referring to.
No, he calls my show and calls me a loser.
I don't know what he's referring to when he's saying I'm not Googling you or whatever. But Mark, your page that you started isn't from Googling James. You started a page on Facebook called what?
Things that James Whitakind, that's his full name, James Whitakind says.
Now, these are not Googled quotes from James Whit that you're posting to that page. You're posting actual texts that he sends to us via the Skype. We talk about how you can call in on Skype. That's what he does. And something else you can do on Skype is you can just send text messages over Skype. And so
it's useful to have that because if somebody calls in, then they can say, I'm calling from Poughkeepsie and I want to talk about this thing.
Put their topic in there. But James types all kinds of very hate-filled sounding texts, essentially, that he sends over. That's all you've been doing. You've just been copying and pasting his actual text onto a Facebook page.
Just Control-C. That's all I do.
Right. So, I mean, he's acting like you're doxing him or something like that. You've never
doxed him. Well, he doesn't like
him.
That his full name and his picture is on the site, but I feel like I have to document the things this guy says. I find him to be a threat. If I end up dead in the next year, I believe that James should be one of the suspects. Like, this guy is obsessed. And if you go and you go look for things James Whittakine says on Facebook, you will find some vitriolic rants that I don't know how you use any term that's not obsessed in talking about these things.
Isn't it true?
I'm not the first talk show host.
Yeah, so I was going to ask you. There are other hosts in the Liberty world, right? Ernie Hancock?
Some have called. I don't know the specifics of the situation, but as I understand it, the police have been called on him for these kind of things.
Because they actually
live in
Arizona. Ernie actually lives nearby.
Right. I don't want to do that. But, it's not a plane ride from Phoenix to Manchester isn't that expensive if you want to, do such a thing. So I just what I'm trying to do is just document things here.
Yeah. So there you go. Oh, it's Things James Whittakine Says. Is that what it's called?
Yeah.
On Facebook. So if you want to check that out, you can do that. We are out of time for tonight. You can join us online.
If James wants me to take it down, he can start acting like a real human being.
All right. So we'll see you tomorrow night online in the meantime at freetalklive.com.
It's now been 7 days since a group of hikers went missing in Maine's Acadia National Park, but rescue crews there are still holding out hope of finding them alive. Autistic reporter Michael Falk is on the scene there. Michael.
Hello, Brooke. My socks got wet. That cameraman gave me new socks. I am fine.
That's good, Michael, but what's the situation there?
The names of the hikers are Casey Allman, Brian Emery, Ashley Thorson. The hikers were last seen 174 hours ago. Since then, three very big storms have hit here. There's a 1.24% chance that all of the hikers are alive. Why are you looking for the hikers?
Well, we're still hopeful that we might be able to find them. There's been a break in the weather, so we're hoping that...
Over the past 7 days, the average high temperature has been 21 degrees Fahrenheit. Over the past 7 days, the average low temperature has been 6 degrees Fahrenheit.
Right. So, we did another sweep of the park from the air, but we didn't see anything.
Without shelter, the human body can withstand temperatures this cold for a maximum of 3 hours. Is there shelter in the forest for the hikers?
Not that we know of.
They're frozen.
Well, we like
This is the Onion News Network.
My name is Jacob Hornberger. I'm president of the Future of Freedom Foundation, which Congressman Ron Paul awarded for having an outstanding freedom website. Write us at fff@fff.org, and we'll send you a free 3-month subscription to our monthly journal of libertarian essays and our booklet, Economic Liberty in the Constitution, which George Mason University economics professor Walter Williams praised in a recent column. That's fff@fff.org.
The three most important things you can do for Free Talk Live are, one, share one episode a week on Facebook or in some other social networking site. Two, buy the things you buy online through shop.freetalklive.com. Three, give $5 a month to the AMP program. You likely buy all kinds of things online. Amazon is the largest online retailer. You can get what you need at the same prices with free Super Saver shipping by going to shop.freetalklive.com. Please do your online shopping at shop.freetalklive.com.
The live edition of Liberty Conspiracy is next, after the news, here on the Liberty Radio Network, LRN.FM.
This is the Liberty Beat, your daily source for Liberty news and activist updates, online at thelibertybeat.com. I'm Brian Hagan with your Liberty Beat for Friday, February 20th, 2015. Gold opened today at $1,207, down $2. Silver opened at $16.32, down 16 cents. And Bitcoin is trading around $247. Today's metal price is brought to you by Midas Resources Incorporated, helping clients convert their paper 401ks and IRAs to solid gold and silver. Get their 10 Reasons book free by calling 800-686-2237. That's 800-686-2237. How much food is in your pantry right now? Could you feed your family for 2 weeks? 1 week? How about even 3 days without any help? Well, keeping an emergency food storage kit is the most effective way to begin to ensure your family's well-being during an emergency. eFoods Direct is food security for whatever the future holds. Go to eFoodsDirect.com/LibertyBeat or call 800-620-5520 to learn more about food security in a time of crisis. In the news, the president of Sudan has made headlines after claiming that Islamic extremist groups ISIS and Boko Haram are a creation of the Central Intelligence Agency and Israel's Mossad. President Omar al-Bashir told Euronews both stand behind the organizations as, quote, there is no Muslim who would carry out such acts, end quote. Al-Bashir also warned against taking violent actions against the groups, stating it would only elicit more violence. The statements echo similar claims made by the leader of Lebanon's Hezbollah group and the mayor of the Turkish city Ankara, who also claimed the Mossad was involved in the Charlie Hebdo attacks in Paris. The U.S. Department of Justice will likely sue the Ferguson, Missouri Police Department if recommendations are not implemented. The news comes as Attorney General Eric Holder is expected to announce the conclusions of a DOJ investigation into the shooting of Michael Brown and the Ferguson Police Department. CNN reports the DOJ would be forced to sue the department if they do not agree to review and revise tactics. Ferguson Police Chief Thomas Jackson stated he has heard nothing new from the Justice Department. DARPA is developing a new search engine specifically focused on the so-called dark or deep web. Known as Memex, the project is being worked on by 17 different contractor teams with the goal of gathering content largely missed by the major search engines, as well as cataloging thousands of sites on the deep web. The Liberty Beat is sponsored by the Free State Project. Want to find liberty in your lifetime? Then join thousands of others who are making the move to New Hampshire, the freest state in the Union. To learn more or to pledge to move today, visit freestateproject.org. Support also comes from Central Texas Gunworks, your online source for firearms, firearm accessories, and ammunition. They take major credit cards and now accept Bitcoin. Visit them online at shop.centraltexasgunworks.com. This is the Liberty Beat for Friday, February 20th, 2015. Check out the website at thelibertybeat.com. New documents from whistleblower Edward Snowden reveal the National Security Agency and the British hacked into a SIM card manufacturer in the Netherlands and now has access to encryption keys that allow monitoring of voice calls and metadata. The Intercept released the new documents, which show the agency's gained access to encryption keys that are built into the SIM cards and now monitor mobile communications without approval or knowledge of the company or foreign governments. The target of the hack was Gemalto, a SIM card manufacturer that produces SIM cards for 450 wireless companies, including AT&T, Sprint, T-Mobile, and Verizon. The Electronic Frontier Foundation stated they believe the NSA and GCHQ violated international law. Following a recent court decision, thousands of people have signed up for a collaborative challenge to spying campaigns by the British government communications headquarters. Human rights group Privacy International has launched an initiative that allows anyone in the world to join their efforts to file a lawsuit against the Investigatory Powers Tribunal. The tribunal recently ruled the GCHQ had violated the law by sharing data with the National Security Agency. The lawsuit would seek specific details on what individuals have been targeted by the GCHQ. The Liberty Beat is brought to you by CoinArch, offering innovative online trading solutions for Bitcoin. Visit CoinArch.com and sign up using coupon code MAX and get free brokerage for the first 7 days. It only takes $10 to start an account. That's CoinArch.com. Support also comes from the Conscious Resistance Network. Videos, news reports, and articles from a spiritual anarchist perspective. Experience the Conscious Resistance at theconsciousresistance.com. This is the Liberty Beat for Friday, February 20th.